Welcome to the Denver Coliseum in Denver, Colorado for this final game of the 2023 Women's USA Curling National Championships. The winner of this title game will advance to the World Championships in Sandviken, Sweden in April. I suppose it's in March. Men's is in April. We're getting a little loopy towards the end here, folks. We're going to make it through. Here in the booth, one last time, Tyler George, joined by the immortal Rich Rune. And Rich, thanks so much for joining us in the booth today.
Thanks for having me, Tyler. I'm looking forward to it. Should be a good game.
Here is our championship bracket. Peterson Strouse with a rematch of the 1-2 game. Big comeback by Team Peterson with a 4-point end in the 10th to take the win 11-10. And now they will play in the final once again. Here are our matchups. Team Tabitha Peterson 7-0 through the round robin and win the 1-2 game 8-0 on the week. Delaney Strouse's squad 6-1 in the round robin. They were the number 2 seed. Here are our lineups for Team Peterson. Lead Tara Peterson. Second, Rebecca Hamilton. Third, Corey Tesey. Skip Tabitha Peterson and coach Kathy Overton Clapham. And for Team Strouse, alternate Susan Dutt. Lead, Rebecca Rogers. Second, Sydney Mullaney. Third, Anna O'Hara. And skip, Delaney Strouse, coached by Courtney Benson. We will pause for the playing of the national anthem. Back with you now, and Rich, this game, I think a lot of people are excited for as curling fans, whether you're fans of Team Peterson or Team Strouse. The fireworks that we saw in the 1-2 game with that 11-10 finish, a lot of shot making both ways. This is going to be a really fun one to watch.
Yeah, both teams have been playing well all week, and Delaney was making everything last night, keeping her team in it, and so fully expect a good game here. We'd like to see a nice close one, huh?
I think by anybody's estimation this week, these have been the two best teams. Team Strouse's only losses of the week coming to Team Peterson. This is the third time these two teams will play. Always tough to beat a team three times if you're Team Peterson, but they are undefeated. They are the number one ranked team in the country. They are the undefeated squad for the week, and they expected to be in this game. And for Team Strouse, Rich, I think those of us that have been watching this team over the course of this season aren't real surprised by this result. But for a lot of people who maybe didn't follow the university games or anything leading up to this, maybe a little bit of a surprise to see them in this final.
Yeah, I think they've been playing well a lot of the year, and especially in the university games. You know, they're one bad break away from winning silver or gold rather than bronze at that thing. So we're fully expected them to be here, I think, at least fighting to get into this game. So
Two and a half.
Rebecca Rogers with the first stone of this championship final. Been so impressed with her play this week.
You gotta go, girl.
So consistent.
Just for weight.
fine. Setting her team up with good rock placement and starting off with a good center guard to start once again.
Good backs. Good spot.
No surprise from Team Strouse pushing the action early on. And Rich, Tab really doesn't want to end up chasing on these ladies. They really like controlling the center of the ice. So Tara Peterson playing this intern come around draw to start.
Yeah, they're going to go right after them. I think, you know, a couple of the other playoff games with the women, they were throwing it in right away and wasting a couple ends. And these guys are going to go right after each other. And that makes it more fun, too.
Yeah, we definitely like that up in the booth. And a perfect come-around draw from Peterson to start right to the top of the forefoot.
Right on top. Right on top. 14-7's close here.
Team Strouse following suit. They'll play the out-turn come-around draw. Playing to a freeze. Rebecca Rogers second.
Split.
I'm great. Both teams able to pick whatever stones they choose for this final. Talking with John Schuster, his team played these red stones from sheet C.
Lock it on, girls, straight.
The entire set. You are able to mix and match if you choose to, but Schuster elected just to play that red set.
The throwbacks, really nice.
Another great shot by Becca. She's just been great all week.
Yeah, perfect stone from Becca Rogers, and she's been that steady the entire time. There's a reason why teams get to this point, too. You know, the difference between the teams in the final and the teams that come up a little short, a lot of times is the ability of the front end to set things up. If you're able to attack with your back end stones as opposed to chasing or defending, for these teams, that's a huge thing as they play a lot of draws and put a lot of rocks in play. So you definitely want to be the team that's actually keeping your opponent chasing, and perfectly done again from Peterson. Both leads flawless so far.
Yeah, four perfect shots.
Top 12. Yeah, that should be fine. Okay.
Moving on to the seconds now. Sydney Mullaney also having a wonderful week for Team Strouse. Playing this intern freeze once again, trying to stack rocks underneath. Line
lock
looks pretty good once again.
15-2 should be okay. No, you're good. This is fine. Good,
and
good.
Another perfect shot. So no flinch from either side so far. How high can they stack these, Rich? They gonna come right up to the booth here?
I was thinking the same thing. I think I'd be throwing the run here, but she wants to stack another one.
Becca Hamilton playing the intern freeze once again. Not sure what the punishment is for the first person to miss this freeze.
Apparently it's the easiest shot in curling.
Come on, Court. You got it. Let's go.
TC and Peterson really trying to carry this one. Over curling a little bit. Does get to a four, though, and staggers on the inside. We're going to call that a make as well.
Oh, yeah. That's a good angle on that top rock.
You see Delaney Strouse kind of shrugging like, okay, well, I suppose we could throw another freeze.
Am I freezing?
I assume someone's going to hit here soon.
All right, just a little less.
Well, Rich, with that many stones frozen, you actually have to hit that pretty hard for that last stone to go out. You lose a little bit of the force in every transfer from every rock, so.
Absolutely.
If you want to get all those moving, you gotta chuck it pretty good.
Straight.
This one looks close to top ring again, but a little tight on line.
Okay, roll it, Anna. Roll it.
And a little tap roll, and that's a really good shot there. Moving those redstones to a much better angle for Team Strouse, and Peterson now looking at maybe moving these around because, Rich, those two red stones now in the top 8 foot are at a bad angle for Team Peterson.
Yeah, they're going to fly out of there if they throw a hit on that. So I think she does have to move them now.
You want to peel?
I feel like she should have peeled one shot earlier, but now I don't think you can. I think you need to get the angles better for yourself.
I don't mind the peel. Yeah, I'm not sure about on the peel, as that would open up those two reds. And Rich, I think if you drill that on the nose, all three of those reds might go and you wouldn't lose any yellow.
What kind of weight?
I agree. That's why I think she needs to move them around a little bit here.
Yeah, I like this call by Tab. The peel actually, I think, is going to get you in more trouble than it's going to help. Would have been fun to see it, though. So the outturn bump for Becca Hamilton, just trying to change the angles up and move these around a little bit. Rich, we've seen all week that there's been a little more curl going towards sheet A than sheet B. So expect this to take a pretty hard turn, and it does. It just touches the guard. Rolls all the way to the side of the forefoot. Interesting result there.
How much you have?
Yeah, that rolled to a good spot for them, actually.
Even if you nose, that's good.
So 12-5, the call from Delaney Strouse. So about halfway at their playing with this intern hit, trying to get inside from Anna O'Hara. Southpaw.
It's a lot of lefties out here this week.
I've never seen so many lefties in a tournament than this one.
Mm-hmm.
Had a team on the men's and women's side that had two left-handers both. And this is the women's team. This one over curling.
Okay.
That moves the angles around and splits those reds up. Peterson sitting two, but also sitting fourth and fifth.
I think I like that little run, Tyler.
Yeah, that'll change the angles around really well, and they'll sit
four.
Back line, I don't think we need to throw a ton.
Yeah, I only have half of it, so.
Okay. I think you need a little more than back line, maybe a hack.
Yeah, I think hack is probably the minimum you need to play in order to move that out of the 8 foot. I think it should come down pretty nice to that rock, too. So Corey Teese's first of this championship final. With a little snug out of hand, especially on this line. Starting to turn. This will wreck the guard and open it up.
She had good hack weight.
A couple of chances here, Rich.
Yeah, just let her off the hook a little there.
Okay, 12-5. I got a 14 on it. Yeah.
So she's just going to leave these yellows there for later, it looks like.
You got it.
Sometimes you play it a little too early, so she's going to play outturn hit here. Try to stick in the edge of the forefoot. The angles on those three yellows are pretty good to knock that one off the button, so she's not going to play it yet.
Yeah, I like this call here from Delaney Strouse. The angles still play pretty well with those three yellows that are lined up in the center. You want to make Team Peterson move those stones, so just hit the number two.
Really good ground!
Really turning hard. Need to go to get by. What a great sweep. Great shot.
Excellent result.
Really well thrown by Anna O'Hara, and great sweeping by Rogers and Mulaney.
Board?
Okay. Tab's going to
try to make
that.
We actually removed a rock, Rich. That's the first one of the game.
And she's going to throw the same shot she threw last time, the little run, which is a good call.
Yeah, it should have a good look at it now without that guard in place. So you can play a little more weight at it. Hamilton trying to turn it over and get a little finish.
Yeah, watch the shooter. Okay, Corn, good.
Yeah, we should. Angle's a little better now for Team Peterson.
Yeah, that shot is no longer there, so that's the problem with leaving it an extra shot, but I didn't disagree with her call at all, but now she's got to get another one in here. Or maybe make a soft weight. I don't really like that. That's going to jam. If you hit those two yellows in the front, it's jamming right on your yellow. So I think you got to play a little soft waiter on that one that's just top four.
You see anything?
My first thought was just like a hit and run.
could also just throw the freeze into the pocket of those two stones.
Could do
right?
that too. But I think the problem is if you don't quite get it in there enough, they're just they can what? Play that same shot and you, all day. Your rock's flying out, hit, both of yours. Hey. So
you have two thirds. Little less than. Little
yeah, I think you need
half.
To play a
more
soft weight
half.
Here and just maybe flop over, get rid of one of those reds.
12-5.
Because you're in a little trouble right now.
Good thing for Strouse is if they do pick this redstone out, their yellows are at a very good angle, lined up back towards the rock on the button.
Like the double on the side guy, like you hit half of that. That's the only other thing.
What are you looking at?
The only other thing I see is like playing the double on that side red over there, and you hit like the outside two-thirds of it. What do you think?
Tough to get to that spot to play that double. They're talking about hitting the redstone on the top of the 8 foot that's not on the center line, slashing it into the one on the button. You have to get really close to that guard to make that shot.
Do you like the double on this one over here? I think it might be easier than this
if
double.
If they believe it's there, that's the right shot. But again, it is really close on that guard to make. You could definitely make it slashing your guard in.
Yes.
But Delaney thinks that she can get close enough to this guard that this double is there.
We're gonna wait.
If it is, then I agree with the call.
All right, I like that a lot. You got it, Laney.
Yeah,
you got to be careful right here on these lines this week. This has been a real straight right along the outside of the forefoot.
Right.
Sometimes even backing up, if you, especially if you hit it early. And we're seeing it right here.
It does wreck their own and punches that into their own stone. It looks as though Peterson's sitting three.
Strouse is in a little trouble here already.
Yeah.
That's the problem. I think the shot they had originally called was probably a little easier and a little more makeable and keeps you out of some trouble. That's a unfortunate result for her because now they have two shots to her one.
We put it
and
back.
There's already lane three. And she also changed the angle on those front two yellows. So it's not lined up onto the button.
If it's not over enough, you know.
What do you like here, Tyler?
I don't like leaving the double for Strouse.
Yeah.
Those two in the 4 foot.
Where do you like it? Do you like a guard or do you like it in?
Bury a piece of it. I don't want to be right in front of it.
I don't like it here.
Yeah, you don't want to cross a little bit, then you may leave a triple.
Okay.
Yeah, right on is pretty easy too.
Right, so that's guard? Why I'm leaning towards a guard.
Yeah.
Guard is interesting because that same slash double that they looked at before, now there's a jam rock in the back of the house.
Okay, you gotta fix
so the double may not be there.
You're saying she's got the double yellows?
There would be a yellow tap, but she'd be playing it against a three or a four.
And she'd be bumping it. The angle's not great. I mean, she'd have to hit it on the center line side pretty good to get it closer to the button. So I normally you don't want to throw a guard here, but I don't know. Maybe it is the right call.
Yeah, I'm not real sure that Strouse has a great option if they guard, and that's
right.
That would be the reason.
So three? Two and a half?
Tab Peterson going to play the
we could always corner freeze with
outturn
the
guard.
Then she's got that double, I guess. But okay.
Yeah, just right in front of it.
Yep, this path is nice. 15.
Her first of this first end.
Well, we've noticed on these guards, you really got to get them out there because they curl a lot earlier. And
this side of the sheet especially, yeah.
Yeah.
This is really hooking and coming possibly into the house. Ends up coming all the way in. Boy, does that yellow get all three of those reds moving, Rich?
It might. I think it's probably going to not get the, well, it depends.
Yeah, they're looking at just playing straight in, trying to triple.
I mean, I think you might
the yellow yellow might tick, or I mean it might, the top red might tick the one and tick the back, but I don't know. She's gonna play the nose here for to get rid of two, maybe three if she can touch it.
I'd be tempted just to hammer that yellow
one. Yeah. At least get the double. And if you squirt maybe a little bit more.
I think she could make the triple this way too though if she just tick the top one first.
Well, my concern would be if you redirect off that higher red one that the second red just dead jams into that stone on the button. You still leave a shot for three.
Yeah, but it's like nearly nose here.
Yeah.
All right, you got it, Lainey.
You guys like the ice.
If she just played the straight double, it's almost cornered on that red stone.
It's not bad.
If it does just touch the side of it.
I think that's what she said.
This is going to be real close.
It's falling back a little here. I think she's all right. She's got the nose, I think. Pretty good shot.
Yeah, not a bad result, but there is a hit for three now for Peterson. Just needed to get up another half inch, maybe.
Yeah, it actually moved that red one just an inch, which separated it. Otherwise, it would have made the shot a little tougher, but open hit for three.
So Peterson, pretty good look at this. Seen this line already. And Rich, this will take off if it gets close to the center line on this turn.
Yeah, we noticed that this week. If you're the closer you are to the center line, the more they seem to go, but just an inch or two out and it runs dead straight. So you just have to throw it with nice controllable weight.
Final stone of this first end. Tab Peterson, hit for three. Really curling now. And a great sweep. That will be three for Tabitha Peterson to start off this championship final. After one end of play, Peterson leads Strouse 3-0. Second end here in the 2023 USA Curling Women's National Championship game. Tabitha Peterson leading Delaney Strouse 3-0 at the start of the second end. It's time to talk to you about Warm Room Hero. Is your curling club website clunky and unworkable? Are you tired of your club relying on social media because your website just does not work for your members? Finally, the curling management software your club has been waiting for is here. Check out Warm Room Hero at curling.club today.
Yeah, 16.
Rich, we were talking during the break about a little bit of a lucky break team Peterson got with that bump they attempted to play, chipping a guard and spinning into the side of the forefoot. And that rock really was the one that ended up changing the angles around for team Peterson.
Yeah,
and with that miss from Strouse right afterwards,
lane's good.
Really changed that end around completely.
Yeah, absolutely. And sometimes, you know, in curling, you get a few breaks like that and people probably don't remember that early, but that changed that end around because it rolled into the forefoot, then she had to hit it, and then some angles got moved around, and now she's looking at giving up three or four there. So that was a big break for sure.
And you see the top teams, the elite teams, capitalize on those things too. And I don't know that there was a miss for Team Peterson after that and really positioned well with what they had in the house.
Line's good.
So Peterson goes
straight, if anything.
Straight in with both of the first two stones. well placed by Tara Peterson.
Yeah, this is a strategy we see when people are, when you're up by a little bit, you throw, try to throw one top four, maybe top eight or close to each other in there, and the other team's going to throw up a corner guard and go right in. I am glad that she's going under here, because sometimes I think you panic set in and have to throw two corners, and you don't really need two corners to score a deuce. You just need the 93. One.
Straight. And you're in the second end of a 10-end game.
Yeah.
If you get 2 points here, you're still feeling like you're right back in it. A one-point deficit after two ends would be no big deal. And even if you get forced, there's still a lot of game left. Don't need to press too hard, but this team plays offense as well as anybody in the country. They don't have trouble setting up big ends. And you see the perfect start once again from Becca Rogers. Corner guard and back eights. And Peterson electing to ignore that and come right to the center, trying to dictate the action.
Yeah, like, I'm kind of surprised, actually, that she is coming in right here rather than just a tight guard or freezing on that one that they just threw. But as I think bringing it in here, now they nose you there. If they can nose you and leave two of their rocks lying around, you're in decent shape for Team Strouse. Sounds like it's a guard by accident here, so. Which is, I think, not a bad place for it to be right there.
Yeah, pro side, being short, obviously. Delaney doesn't like that guard, so she's going to try to hit and roll over, not playing a peel, just playing a hit and roll to try to get a second corner guard up.
Yeah, she doesn't want to run in and knock off her own corner guard either here, so I think she's throwing it with a little lighter weight than peel, so she doesn't mess that guard up.
Yes!
She's got one buried behind it.
This one over curling.
Yes!
Now trying to decide where they're going to leave the shooter. Ends up making a pseudo run back.
Okay.
Rolling it under the corner and sitting second count. So all things considered, a pretty good result there for Team Strouse.
Yeah,
she ended up leaving her rock still second shot, which is what she needed, right? So fortunate result for where it ended, where it was coming down on. You never know what was going to happen there, but she left it. She's still sitting second, which is big.
Queen.
Becca Hamlin playing the outturn peel.
Yep. Queen.
Makes no mistake there. Good throw by Becca. Rich, you see the steely gaze of those two coaches behind the bench there, Courtney Benson and Kathy O. The two of them have collaborated a lot this season.
Okay, 14,
if people
7.
Aren't aware, with my sister having her first child this season. Kathy took over for Team Strouse at a bunch of events this year and has been so great for this young squad and tag teaming with helping out. I talked with Kathy after the 1-2 game.
Curl.
And she, as excited she was for her squad, she was heartbroken for the way that finished for Team Strouse. It's also kind of her team as well. So,
yeah, the
bonds out here with these players and these teams, these coaches, the curling community is that way all the time. But for these two, it's a little different with Kathy working with Delaney and her ladies as much as she has.
Yeah, it was nice to see them snap back after that just devastating loss and play well out there this morning. Just because, you know, sometimes we've been on teams, Tyler, where you go in the tank after something like that. So for them to come out and just play a great game and just dominate was nice.
Intern double attempt from Corey Tesey.
Yep, stay on it.
Gets them all going. So over curls a little bit, but makes it with the old plan B, and that's always there. Good read from Tab Peterson. There are those coaches, Courtney Benson.
Yeah, you got it.
Their new mascot, Unicorn, which has remained nameless to this point. And Kathy O over on the other side. Spoke a little bit with Delaney Strouse's team after that semifinal win last night and telling them that regardless of what happens in the final, what they did to bounce back in such a short period of time, going right back on the ice after the way that game ended, that 4-point end for Team Peterson, down three in the 10th, that's the most impressive thing they'll do this week, regardless of this championship final. That, as you said, Rich, we've been on that side of things so many times, and the vast majority of teams that's pretty much the end of it for him. You lose one like that, and then mentally it's so hard to come back for the next one. But Team Strouse came out and played lights out in that semifinal game, looked completely unaffected by the previous game's result. Speaks so much to the mental strength and toughness of this young squad.
Yeah, I mean, clearly they have it, and then they can, if you can bounce back from that, and it never hurts to maybe have a couple conversations with your sports psychologist and just, you know, have each other's backs, I think is a big deal, because, you know, you obviously when you give up four to lose, it's not just one player that did that in one shot. You know, it was a few misses and maybe a little nerves, who knows, but they really came back strong and nice to see.
Yeah, 14 here is really good.
So after that double by Anna O'Hara and a rollout from Corey TC, O'Hara will have this outturn come around draw under their guard, seeing if they can possibly set up a two still. Always nice when you're going under your own team's stone too.
Yeah, that's, you know, rolling out there is, it, people underestimate how big that is, because now here's your chance at two, whereas you had to hit that and maybe you just blank in the end. Now you have a chance for two if you can beat them under.
Rock kind of gliding a little bit. Strouse hoping it doesn't come out the other side too much, but should see a good piece of it on the outturn side. This will be the straighter side of the sheet, Rich, so we'll see if this gets as much turn. Not as straight as we saw early in the week since they papered the rocks. This will be outturn, probably board weight type of hit for Tab Peterson.
Yeah, as long as you, even though this is a straight spot, as long as you're throwing hack, it will still curl. But you pick up the weight here at all, and you can look really bad in a hurry because it just doesn't move.
Hearing hack here from Peterson will be the weight that she'll play.
And that's usually about 12 and a half seconds for most teams, 12 to 12 and a half seconds, hog to hog.
Here is Tabitha Peterson's first stone. Second end of this championship final.
Whoa! No! Yep.
Sweep on and off. Line looks very good. Yep. I'd like to roll this away a little bit, but ends up right there. So decision for Strouse. They can hit this stone or play that same intern draw and set up into either a jam or a freeze. I like the call playing the draw here. It's a good opportunity to find a skips deuce.
I think if she wasn't down three, she'd probably just hit this and take the blank, even if she was only down one or two. But down three, I think this is the right call. You actually have a really good shot. You got two to there, one. You just need to make this, you need to make this top full four. I don't think you want to freeze on this, Tyler. I think you just want to be buried top button.
Yeah, I agree. Frozen is your plan B, but top button leaves you enough room for a second point, and you can come around the opposite direction if you needed to as well, if Peterson did freeze on that stone. And again, with the three-point lead, or three-point deficit for Team Strouse, you don't want to run out of ends. You know, you want to take as many opportunities as you can to try to score multiple points. So with this opportunity, I like to call. Hear that this
bring
is over curling, so they're playing to a freeze. Needs to go for line to not cross that stone too.
I got 14-7 on that hog to hog, so ice is pretty consistent with what it's been the last few days since they papered them.
I would think that the cautious approach here, Rich, just peeling this out would probably be the right play.
Absolutely. You can see half. I think you can just rip it off. You got enough room in between those rocks. You hit any piece of it, it'll go out.
Heard 10-5, the call from Peterson. Little surprised that they're playing this with finesse weight instead of just playing kill.
Yeah, I'm throwing this a little harder probably, at least normal at a minimum.
I agree. I think I'm just playing peel and losing both. Because even if you miss that back stone completely, Strouse is likely playing the peel to blank.
Yep.
You expect her to make it. So I don't know what you're really gaining except that they're trying to play force by sticking around, but it's kind of a tricky little spot to try to miss that back stone and still stay in the house.
Yeah, and you're probably rolling out even with control anyway if you hit it in the right spot.
Peterson second. Second end of this final.
She's
fading back a little bit right now. Amelin needs to turn this to get a piece. And does end up just picking it out.
That's in that spot where we talk about that it does fade a little bit, just getting it, you start throwing closer to 10 or under. That was about a 10 and a half. You saw that just ran there. It faded back even an inch or two, but they got it up.
You don't even have to throw a ton of weight if you don't want to. Like, we can sweep a roll.
I'm talking about, like, peeling it out.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So I think peel if you're going to do that. Right?
Yeah, that is the correct call here. You're playing for the blank.
You could throw, like, 9.5 and sweep a roll.
You can make it with whatever weight you want, really, with where this guard is.
Like
anything
whatever.
Normal up.
Okay. I was just offering it.
But again, you want to be careful because you start throwing peel here, it might back up a little. So just got to be aware of that.
It's like she's playing.
She pops. Her out turns good.
Yeah, fading back a little bit. Just gets enough of it. 100% in the books. Strouse gets the blank and will carry the hammer to the third end. Score after two. Peterson 3, Strouse 0. Third end of this championship final 2023 USA Curling Women's National Championships. Tyler George and Rich Ruinen here in the booth. Rich, I know the week didn't go quite like you hoped, but speaking with your young charges that you had on the squad, they really enjoyed the experience. That's going to do a lot for them and their curling careers going forward. I'm sure it was a lot of fun playing with those guys. Makes you feel young again, too.
Yeah, at my age, it's hard to feel young, but they definitely learned a lot. I think that was my goal. I mean, it would have been nice to get a couple more wins. We actually
really
very
good.
Easily could have been 3-1 to start the week. Had a couple of crucial misses up and down the lineup, and me included. So, but it was good. It was really fun, and I hope they learned a lot. And they're all good curlers and good kids. And I say kids, they're 20, but when you're 51.
Yeah, people have to remember
when we
say young guys or kids, it's a term of endearment. You know, we're not trying to make them sound young and inexperienced. So it's
sure.
A big brother role.
Yep.
Yeah,
maybe not quite father figure, but big brother we'll go with, huh?
Yeah, it was fun though. You know, I think they learned a lot. Anytime you come here, you grow as a curler, I think, and in your development with the mental side of the game too. Just being here and having been here before, now they go back, they'll know some of the things, what to expect.
Go ahead. Top four, ladies.
You got it. Keep going.
Tara Peterson, second.
Keep going.
Of this
back.
Third end. Playing the intern draw, trying to get at least a tight guard, if not on the paint. Does get to a biter. Had to pause there to see if it actually was going to make it. Rogers now going under the corner again. Similar start to the previous end. Again, Rich, this is the fastest line on this sheet. Always is, on most curling sheets, center line out, and we've said it almost every game this week, especially with Sean Olesen, Dave Stavateg's ice, that center line track is so much faster than the rest of the sheet, and 90% of the misses that we've seen going middle out with draws and even with soft weight hits have been on the heavy side or the wide side.
Yeah, definitely. We had that happen several times where, you know, we threw it to the back or just through, you know, back 12 or just through, and we're wanting it a little higher. So you just have to be cognizant of that and talk about it, you know, and know you can sweep it there.
And that was the one blip really we saw from Team Schuster in the men's final this afternoon. And, one end, Blies and Schuster both going deep or through. On the intern going away, center line out. But that's about all they missed. There wasn't much.
Yeah. They were pretty good today.
10-5.
Yeah, that's, you know, I talked to John and these guys after the game, and it's, I guess the best compliment you can pay a team like that is that even sitting here in the booth after that two in the first, it kind of felt inevitable, you know, Thanos style. You know, they snap the fingers and that's it. It's, you know, it's all over. But again, a fantastic week for Danny Casper. And we talk a lot on the broadcast about how impressive that young team is. And for Danny in particular, at 21 years old, accomplishing what they did, you know, I'm sure it's a bitter taste having the final go the way it did. But to get to the championship game, take the silver medal from the men's championship at this point. Such a bright future for that squad.
Yeah, that doesn't usually happen where you get a team, you know, a young team like that getting into the final at age 21. It usually takes a few years, so that definitely a great week. Yeah. But you also know that, you know, that experience, you know, Schuster, they played like they've been there before. Think they have?
You know? Yeah, yeah. It wasn't really their first rodeo.
Yeah.
Saw a little apology from Tab Peterson there to Delaney Strouse on that accidental run back takeout. Just playing the peel and ended up making the run.
Okay, always that's, curl.
We kind of compare that to in tennis when you hit one that hits the top of the tape and drops over. You put the hand up.
Yes! Hard curl! Hard!
Trying to get back underneath that guard again.
Hard!
Mostly buries underneath. Good shot from Mulaney.
Yep, let's go.
Peterson playing the peel once again. This will be Corey Tesey's first. Duluth's own Corey Tesey, of course, we have to mention that. Watched Corey since she was a tyke. Another one of those players that makes us feel ancient as we watch them play in this national championship. But so proud of Corey and how far she's come as a player and accepting this role on this squad after skipping for so long as a third, when that opportunity opens up to join the top team in the country, you look at it as a means to an end. That's, yeah, if you're used to skipping, you like that role, you like being in the spotlight, but you know, the end goal is to put together the best team you possibly can to give yourself the best chance to get your country on the podium in world events. And that's obviously the route that this team is trying to go. And for Tab, picking up a player like Corey to fill Nina Roth's very large shoes in a metaphorical sense. We're not talking Flies and Huffman feet as we were earlier. But, with such a strong player in Nina Roth and filling in for her, Nina taking time away for family. It's great. It's been fun watching this team come together and the chemistry that they have, and they both have nothing but good things to say about playing with each other too.
Yeah, I think she's fit in really well with this team so far, and you know, she's one of the best shooters in the country too. So you had someone like that, it never hurts.
Yeah, and from Corey's side to be able to just take that skipping weight off your shoulders and go out and play third and make everything. I know I had that same experience. Playing with John, where it's a lot of fun just to go out there and make everything for a really good skip and have somebody that can put that broom in the right spot and give you the best chance to succeed, which Tab Peterson certainly does for Corey. You see another good shot from her there. So Anna O'Hara trying to get the inside roll. They get in front of that red stone, things start to get interesting for a possible at least two. This again, straighter side on the sheet.
10,
Rich,
seven.
Just
okay, good.
Not turning over.
Good.
But does play into an interesting angle. If Peterson did take on the double, it might jam on their own red. They'll probably just hit number one count with this three-point lead.
Yeah,
try to roll underneath the yellow would be a good spot, as I don't believe that a nose run would get the shooter in the rings.
No, I agree, but I think it never hurts on these to not roll fully buried, roll like three quarters so that they can't stuff it right under on your next one. You know, if they run that yellow back and hit it right on the nose, then you're in a little trouble. So if you roll like half under, they've got to make a decision on what they're going to do. If they're going to play that run or they're going to try to pick you out. So I think that would be a little bit better, but either way, you want to roll here a little bit.
Down.
10-5 is what we call control weight.
This one going backwards a little bit too. Peterson trying to turn it over to stick around. Does end up in a pretty good spot. Not much of a double there.
No, it's definitely a decent spot for her.
Yeah.
And we see that straight spot again. You know, it's really straight in this, right off the, you know, middle of the 4 foot to the just inside the 8 foot, and this is the straighter side as well. So, I think you could tighten up the broom and sweep here. It'd be the way to play this shot.
Yeah.
Still seems like a lot of ice for 10-5.
Yeah, I agree. And you really want to give your sweepers a chance on these too. If it's on the wide side, there's not a whole lot you can do turning it over even on that straight line.
Yep.
So important here for Strouse to get this roll in. If they can get underneath their own, does bring at least two back into play. So need to be aggressive on this roll. It's definitely an aggressive line, Rich. This is on the inside of the stone, but.
Oh, push! Yeah.
Oh, that's
really good shot.
Great shot from Strouse. That roll, the only way that they're creating a two-point end here. Now, Peterson probably has to take on the double, but that does bring possible three into play, although I think if that back red or back yellow jams on the red, the top yellow may go out still.
Yes, I think so too. I don't think you're at risk of leaving two, but definitely you got to get rid of one of these, I think.
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of risk here for Peterson. Yeah. If that rock rolls another 2-3 inches, now you're in an interesting spot where that double plays dead into the jam, so you may just be trying to pick the backstone out instead. But hit this just a hair high, three quarters, probably good enough to make this double.
And you might even roll onto the rings, which would be huge because you'd get it. It'd secure the force for you.
Yeah, it'd be very close. Tab Peterson's final stone of this third end. In turn double. Good clean throw from Peterson there.
No!
Needs to get up just a little bit. Oh, it papers by, takes one off, so a little more breathing room. One for the swear jar for Tab as well.
Yeah,
haven't had too many of those this week, Rich. I think you had one.
Oh, we didn't go draw.
I think I know which one it was.
I think 14-8-15.
So she's going to have a free.
That pretty good. Just kind of ran on her a little bit.
Yeah, she just missed it to even pick off that back red. She must have missed it by less than a quarter inch on the front rock, probably. So, but now you get a free draw for two here.
And that shows how important that roll was, Rich, to bring that into play. And that extra point, if Strouse is able to make this draw, huge difference between 3-1 and 3-2.
Absolutely. You She was looking like Tab was looking like she was gonna get the force, and when we say that, we mean hold them to one, right? And
yeah, this team is relentless. You have to be prepared for this for the rest of the game. They're gonna come at him tooth and nail with everything they have. Delaney Strouse makes no mistake with this draw.
He's gonna slow down across.
Perfectly done.
Good.
That is two for Team Strouse. Climbing back into this game. Buckle up, folks. It's gonna be a fun one. Peterson leads 3-2 after three.
Twin Cities Orthopedics is ready to go with more doctors, specialty services, and convenient urgent care locations. Ready, set, TCO.
End here, women's final, 2023 USA Curling National Championships.
Straight.
Tabitha Peterson, Delaney Strouse. Strouse getting a two
straight
back in the third to cut the deficit to 3-2. And Rich, you mentioned during the break,
we'll get it at two. We're over curling.
This end is a huge momentum end for both teams. You know,
like
Strouse getting that two, showing they're not going anywhere. Peterson still with a 1-point lead in the hammer, but you know, if this ends up being a steal for Strouse or a two for Peterson, it kind of shows which direction this game may go going forward. And you can really halt that momentum for Strouse if your team Peterson with a strong end and maybe putting up a two.
Yeah, this is, you know, it's the even end. But when you just get back in this game here, what you really needed to do is force or steal here. If you give up a two, you're back to kind of square one, just like you were right before this down three. So this is a really important end for both teams.
And after the blank in the second and then waiting to get that two in the third, you feel like you battled for a couple ends to get to this point. So if it only takes one for it to flip back, like you said, and get back to a 3-point lead, it's a little bit discouraging. So this end, again, mentally for both teams, so important. Really like to see Team Peterson, if you're a fan of their squad, play their best end right now and put together eight good shots. And for Team Strouse, same thing. Continue that momentum from that 2-point end and see if you can get this thing knotted up or get a force to take the hammer to the fifth. Sweeper's really going hard to get by the guard and does. Should come out the other side on that path.
Still a good shot there.
Yep, pretty good shot.
Overcurl just a little, but good shot. Probably give her full 100% on that one. She's probably, I think she's shooting 100%.
Yeah,
so
we don't want to. We don't want to ruin the 100% game. I think she's close to it, if not on it. Nothing new from Becca Rogers this week, and Tara Peterson. I think by most people's estimation, maybe
like
the top
split
lead in the women's game.
But the red took like.
But Becca Rogers
and, like,
will not.
Like,
will not falter here.
I made it do that, but I'm
it's fun to watch these two matching shot for shot. You know, even at the lead position with simple shots, just seeing the execution, how precise it is still really fun to watch. And there's another one there with that going around. Not sure if that was the play or not. You see some low fives, so.
Did you get a time?
We'll call that a make as well.
14-2.
I thought maybe they were just playing to a tap on that yellow stone.
Yeah, I really like the kind of back line weight there and just tap, try to get to the nose, inside a nose, and move that one to the back. And then you have total control of the front. So, unfortunately, I didn't see exactly what she called.
Hard straight.
Sweeper's trying to hold the line. This may overcurl on the
swingier
side of the sheet.
Yep.
Not a terrible result. Angle's still playing pretty good for Team Strouse. Those yellows are lined up directly to that redstone. So Peterson can only hit one of them.
Yeah, I mean, we can roll all the way over here, too. Yeah. We need to stay up here. I just don't really want to hit it high.
Right.
Obviously. Yeah. But you have all of it, hey?
Yeah.
Do you like board?
Yeah.
Okay.
So she's going to try to hit this and roll maybe just across out the other side even of the guard. It isn't bad here to take a big roll way out to the 8 foot.
11-5.
So Becca Hamilton 11, trying to get to the inside of this 11, stone, maybe. Really need to turn over to do that. They end up moving both of these stones.
Yep.
Moves their own to open. Neither one goes. Things starting to get a little jumbled up once again. I don't think either team has a problem with that. And for Team Strouse, trying to put something together for a steal or a force, they like all these rocks in play.
10-5.
Of course, they like all those rocks in play
like
all the time, pretty much.
Yeah, they're pretty aggressive. No question about it. It makes for fun watching curling. You know, you get teams that like a lot of rocks around.
Just hitting this rock in the back of the 8 foot, trying to sit second, third, and fourth.
Yep. Hi. Sorry,
that takes a hard turn there.
My bad.
Rolls behind the redstone instead. Just took a little jump on Delaney there.
Kind of thinking we have to peel.
Yeah. We'd laugh watching this team play in past years, Rich, where they were just so relentless with the draw game that, I mean, they'd made so many of them, and you live and die by the sword when you play that aggressively.
Whoa.
It's not the same team now as it used to be. They still are very aggressive with the draw game, but they're smarter about when to apply it, and they don't get themselves into trouble in bad scoreboard situations
maybe
they did in past years.
I
but
think it's a little high here.
And I think there
was no team that was more entertaining to watch than them when they were in that we're going to draw the lights out and you can't stop us.
I think they've developed a really good hit game too over the last couple of years, maybe that they didn't have 3 years ago. You know, they've been able to throw the up weight and the run backs and that kind of stuff, and that's really really helped their success too, because every now and then you got to bail out too when you play this aggressive, so you need to be able to throw a high hard one.
Not a bad setup right now for Team Strouse. Just looking to play a tap on this rock in the top of the 4 foot.
A tap
to a freeze would be ideal.
Yep.
Sweeper's really getting a workout so far in this game for Team Strouse. Rogers and Mulaney trying to hold this.
Hard.
Really good sweep just to get it to there.
Yep. Pretty good result, but you can see all three of these probably could go pretty easily. You hit this three quarters high with the outturn, the right as we're looking at it down there, and just a little high, and all three of those yellows go flying out, I think.
I think I like it like that versus here, because then, I mean, that's not bad either, I guess. You stay right up there, as long as you clip these two. But we're still behind T line. And you might get most of them moving if you do it like that.
Yeah, I like that.
A little surprised they're thinking of playing it this way, Rich, as opposed to the inside where you can get them all going.
Yeah, I think you can get them all going a little bit this way too, but I honestly think if you just hammer it just basically nose just a tiny bit high, they all go flying out, and you're sitting right in front of your rock that's behind the tee. So,
I agree. And they will all move. I'm not sure if they all go unless it kicks off of their own red stone in the back of the forefoot.
Hard! Yep, you gotta stay.
See, that's the way she wanted. She should have made it.
Yeah, that was the way we were expecting. Strouse still sitting first, though.
Yeah, she just, we see that again right by the center line. Sometimes they just go a little bit there, and that one moved on them, and they actually hit it on the opposite side that they were calling, but it was still
the broom here.
Like
It'll
we
curl.
That's what we were talking about. That's kind of the side I thought she should hit on. So
a little bit of a conservative call this time from Strouse. Mm-hmm. Not a bad call, but I think this team in the past
queen,
may have thrown the freeze on that back red.
Whoa, queen.
Which I wouldn't mind right now either. But just hitting and trying to roll over a little bit.
Whoa, yep. Whoa. Good.
Rolls into the 8 foot for second count. Third count.
I think that's a good call. I mean, you're flirting. Even if you miss the freeze or bump it too far, you never know. You could be in big trouble because you have three reds in the house. So eliminating one, roll into there. It's not a bad call at all, actually. What you need to do is somehow figure out a way to get the force here if your team Strouse and Tab Peterson wants to get two here. So, and either could happen with this setup.
Yeah, 9-6.
Close.
9-6.
Spin double.
We're past it. Sorry. I had to go right away. Okay.
That goes over the top and Tab was saying that it was past the double spot. I'm not sure it was. I mean, that still made contact with that on the yellow stone.
It actually touched the yellow stone, so if they stay on that, I think she's got the double, accidental double. But now because Strouse hit the one on the outside, and then they got a big break with them rolling out here, and now she's hitting delay two. So the force is definitely on here.
Yeah, a little bit of an error there on the read from Tab, a rare one. You heard, I believe it was Tara calling for the thin double halfway down, but ends up rolling out. So, as you said, Rich, the hit should maybe at least be able to set up a force here. I think you almost want to roll this all the way under your own.
Yeah, that's not a bad call either.
Yeah.
You have to stay, though. That's the main thing, because then you're laying one and two, and you got the force on. So
this looks like nose. That's just fine. No double opportunity there unless it's a run. So it does set up a situation where there's a big area for Peterson to throw this draw that sets it up in a good spot.
Yeah, a lot of inexperienced skips might think, hey, let's just go hit one of these two or play that run back, but Tab's gonna go for her. She wants a deuce bad here, and she's money when it comes to drawing. She's always finding the 4 foot, so she's gonna make looks like she's gonna draw under the red just barely, but be full four, okay. Kind of cornering that yellow rock on the side 4 foot.
I heard Tab say if it overcurls, then Strouse will be shot rock because of that rock in the back of the 4 foot.
4-6, 4-7. It's going to be a slightly different path, but it's still pretty good. Okay.
Peterson's first here in the fourth, looking for a freeze on Strouse's number two counter to sit first.
They're saying it's really light.
Just there.
Sweepers still think that they're there. Really carrying this.
5-6.
Just here. Just here.
Maybe bruised it a little bit now. Swept it right into that pole.
All right, not bad. Just they had to ghost for so long that they couldn't really worry about the line, and it ended up being pretty good, but it needed to curl another 4 inches.
Yeah. Just like half a rock. Try to keep our shooter.
I would be tempted to throw a little more weight.
I like keeping our rock around.
Yeah. Maybe 11-5 here, Anna.
11-5.
I would be a lot more comfortable with that weight with this shot. Yeah, because if you click off your own yellow, you want this to spill out no matter what.
Yeah, I think you want to throw at least 11-5 here. And it doesn't really even matter if you stay. I mean, yeah, it's a bonus if you do, but she's still going to throw the draw against two.
Yeah, just like half a rock, two thirds.
Sometimes when you lighten up, when you're crossing the center line too, it goes on you too, so.
10-5!
10-5!
Yep.
An think they got to go on this, I think.
This that line should run pretty straight until it climbs the center. Now it's getting over that.
And she threw it a little harder than she had asked for, so that ran nice.
Nice shot there from Strouse. Playing the nose, but Rich, there is a spot you can hit this, that this could roll between these yellow stones.
Yeah, she absolutely has to stay here. You're right. You hit half a rock, it might just skinny between both those yellows on the left side of the sheet.
Yeah, it kind of shapes just perfectly for the roll between for where you'd have to hit it. If it hits thin enough that it would roll out of the forefoot, it's exactly on the line that it would go between those two stones. John Benton asking if the wheel triple is there. I think it is, but I'm going to say they don't play it in this spot with a one-point lead and hammer. On-off sweep.
That's usually a good sign.
Fine. Had a good shot by Peterson. Makes no mistake with that hammer hit and stick for one. Well played end by Team Strouse to get that force and have her throw against three. So after four ends of play, Peterson now leads Strouse 4-2.
The everyday person may not aspire to be a professional athlete or an Olympic athlete. You may just want to be the best person you can be. You just may want to sleep better. You may want to feel better. Thorne has many products that can support all of those things. So it's not just about performing or running faster or jumping higher. It's those little things that go into having a higher quality of life.
On to the fifth in our women's championship final, Tabitha Peterson, Delaney Strouse. Tab leading 4-2 in the fifth end. And Rich, we were doing the math on what it takes to come back from a 3-0 deficit. As long as you can go score two, force one, score two before the end of the game, you're always in it. And one more deuce here from Team Strouse could already get them back to even at the break.
10-5, you got it.
So yeah, she's that's what she wants here is to get a deuce here to in the fifth to tie it up halfway through. So, but she is.
Yes!
What do you think? She's maybe hitting this to do a delayed corner.
I have to assume this is a delayed corner play, but Rogers really turned this over out of hand.
You're
I'm not sure she has anything.
All right, you're off it.
Poor release on that one. As good as she's been all week, that was not her best effort.
I think we jinxed her last end when we said she's shooting 100%.
Could be the long-term jinx, yeah. Because it was after that other throw, so may have to take another one on the chin here in the booth.
Okay, we got lots of room right now. Take
another
a
free round at the 3-7 bar for the announcer jinx.
Line's really nice. Careful on the curl. Whoa. Oh, it's going to overcurl, I think.
I think announcer jinx might have been one of those home game rules too. We won't mention exactly what type of game people are playing, but I think you could probably draw your own conclusions.
Yeah. Just take
one of those other points would be mentioning Dr. Pepper Zero Sugar. So I think I'm gonna have a sip on one last bottle here for the week. I'd like to thank Dr. Pepper for helping me get through this week. 17 games, Richard. It's been a long one, but a lot of fun. It's fun mixing it up in the booth with lots of different people coming up here and different vibes throughout. So it's been a lot of fun.
Yes, a lot of work, I'm sure. It gets tiring. I've done it a few times, but never 17 games. But yeah, it's a lot. It ends up being a lot of work, more than you think.
I skipped one game this week. The final draw of the four draw day.
Like this turn.
That was probably for the best. I mean, you've listened to me for almost five ends now. Imagine doing it for 17 games.
Yeah.
You know, that's a lot to ask of anybody.
Yeah.
John Benton saying 16 is plenty. Is that where you draw the line? This is it? We refine it till this one? So a couple well-placed freezes now. Gets by the guard, too, for Peterson.
So we talked about, you know, Becca's one miss just gets Strouse in a little bit of trouble here right away. So, you know, they're going to have to try to bail out of this probably. And you're just hoping you don't get forced here. And maybe you can still manufacture a two later. But right now you're in a little trouble. So you just need to run this back and hope a couple of the Reds leave.
Yeah, just 7-5.
I don't mind the run here. They also could chisel that red rock in the top of the 8 foot out with hack and spread them out a little bit and get another yellow rock in the house. But as long as the shooter stays for Delaney, then you still have a rock you can use to try to score your two.
Pretty good shot there.
Yeah, if that yellow one sticks around, it's a really good shot.
Really good.
That really shot good. Rock behind that stone. Really, really good result for Strouse, for Sydney Mullaney.
We talked about that hit game. You know, that's big when you can throw it like that and get yourself out of trouble in one shot.
I mean, I like it, but
you've already put Team Peterson now in a position where they have to think about, do we want to draw under the center, under their stone, with them already sitting one with this two-point lead? Tab going back out to slash this, but you play this shot, and Team Strouse goes around the center guard around their own. So that shot by Mullaney completely changes this end around.
Yeah, I think this is the right call up, too. You're just going to have to risk maybe them going beating you under.
Good sweep there from Tara Peterson and Corey Teese to hold that line.
10-5. What? 10-5. We can throw 9-5 out here if you prefer.
Let's throw 9-5.
Yep, you got a little inside rolls, perfect.
That's a veteran move there, Rich. Mm-hmm. Not under throwing stones in the outside of the sheet when it could be a little fresher there, a little slower. Take the ice out of it. Make sure that you're throwing at least normal.
Yeah, we notice you get outside even later in the games because you haven't used it as much that it was breaking sometimes out there if you're throwing anything less than normal. So
just good enough to have the paint. So perfectly done. Sometimes I feel like Delaney moves those rocks with her voice, her mind, that attitude.
Nice 9 here, Cor.
I heard she burned you pretty good. A little while back, told a joke that didn't go over all that well, and Delaney just kind of looked up you deadpan and said, "Nice joke, Rich." Perfect
response. That's probably true.
That will roll all the way out. So here's Strouse's opportunity to get underneath the center guard and got to create that two-point end.
We talked about how important it is to stick on those, you know, because now they get to beat you under the center guard. If you stick anywhere, they're forced to hit it. So that's a, you know, it's a half shot, but it's a big half shot. Now she can go try to get her two here by making a couple of shots in a row.
Straight, 7.
6.
Line's six, good.
7.
7.
Sweepers.
Okay, whoa, line's fine.
Eight is not a bad result here unless they
really
can dig it out.
Six. Top house, 14-8. We want a 6.
Starting to dig. Should stop above the tee, I think.
Good throw.
Good. Pretty good shot. This is accessible for Peterson. Playing the freeze, a little surprised here, Rich.
You know the weight.
Yeah, I am. If you can dig it, I think you need to dig this rock.
Oh, I can dig it. Yeah, this is what happens in game 17. Now the jokes are getting cheesier.
That's just set you
left
up for it.
No, I agree though that if you can get that rock out, if you can dig it out with as much distance, 2-point lead. You don't want to bounce off at all, and even the freeze doesn't necessarily kill the 2-point end for Strouse. Big turn, this turn going towards the sheet A. Crosses and bumps a little bit. Strouse still shot rock. The freeze here for Strouse makes things interesting. Now, not only are you bringing two into play, but maybe a sneaky three, Rich?
Oh, yeah. If you can corner this red one right here, leave your other your shooter like a third or half open, you're going to have a good shot. You're going to have Tab in a little bit of trouble because the angles are good for you, not so much for her. So this is a big shot here.
I think you want to move this like 2-3 inches. Yeah. You don't want it frozen, so if they play any run or hit, that it drags into your own stone. Just a tiny bit of separation. Stay angled on the high side.
Line's perfect. Don't
this line looks really good for that. Can they move this just a couple inches?
I think they're going to. It looks pretty good.
Yeah, I just don't want to sweep it.
Perfect.
Oh, that's really good. Great spot. Things getting a little dicey here for Team Peterson now. And Rich, that goes back to electing to play that freeze as opposed to the hack weight hit and roll.
Yeah, I think she was, you know, she's hoping to get the force, but sometimes that might be a little too aggressive when you have a 2-point lead.
And again, this whole end going back to Sydney Mullaney's run, opening things up.
I mean, I don't think I'm going to corner this yellow because they can hit it with the out turn and lay two. So I think you've got to maybe play off, play your own red back into that back yellow. I think what you got to do, but you can't leave a double. So you got to throw it with probably hack weight or something so you roll out of the way. Hacker board, get it out of the house. So, but it looks like she's electing to just draw in a little tap.
Yeah.
Which, Tyler, that could be pretty dangerous if you if you ever just tick and roll and leave a pocket double to shoot both reds out, and now you're looking at three.
And this is why we were excited for this game, is these two teams are both fearless with these shots in these situations.
She's going to need a good one here. She's got to just, I think she's just trying to bump that red a little bit. Get it right on top of that yellow without rolling too far.
Her tee out of hand. Straighter side of the sheet. Shouldn't see it dive as hard here.
Seven! Six! Six!
Only six
freeze.
Is playing to a freeze and over curling now, too.
Four, five. We're tapping. We're tapping.
Actually works out pretty good.
Works out really good because it moved it far enough where she can't slash it and leave it there. So that actually turned out to be a real good result.
Second pretty good break for
you like just having this?
Team Peterson on a draw that taps something around to a better angle.
What do you like here, Ty? This is a pretty tough setup now for yellow, I think. If you bump it at all,
easy.
They can still see the intern side of those reds.
Easy anyways, unless I guard.
Okay.
Do you like the guard?
Not sure you can guard both.
No, she's going to have you either
guard
way.
Guard our yellow?
No, guard this.
I don't think you ever guard that side because they can come down
there?
With just control.
The and the nose double.
I feel
she can make a nose double.
She has, like, mostly all of this rock, so she has a nose double on our yellow right now.
I don't think we ever guard the yellow.
Is there any hope in just tapping your own yellow, Rich?
Make a play on it, or
changing that angle and trying to corner on the red.
Yeah, if you know what, if you could tap it, just get just a little inside, move it a couple inches, and maybe maybe there's no way for them to get you out of there, you know? So that could be the shot.
I was gonna
say the tough thing is if you tap it back to your own, then the red probably plays into a double, but at least your shooter is still in the top of the 4 foot.
What kind of weight?
Back four?
Yeah.
It looks like that's what they're going to play.
Yeah,
and actually, if you catch this a hair high, as they're saying, you might move that red over so it's lined up straight back away from the yellow. You may line up something with the three yellows over here, maybe a possible triple, but...
I think you got to get just inside of nose. It'd be the, because you'll be a rock higher too, so you're good. I think if you can maybe just straight nose,
yeah,
or just a little bit inside,
yeah,
and then you're at least your rock sitting there safe. I think that one, they might still have this red into it, but.
Delaney Strouse's first stone, fifth end, playing outturn tap on her own in the top of the 4 foot. Like a little bit of outward momentum there.
Oh.
Needs to come up a lot online.
Yeah, it's quite a ways out there right now. She's sweeping to make it curl, and she's getting her there. It's curling. But you do not want to leave this on the high side. Well,
Interesting.
I think
that
might all
be good. Depending on if that yellow stone catches the back of that red, if they play the hit, the yellow stone on the top of the button.
We know the one she just threw, stuffing, but we get rid of two. Can we get,
that's a really interesting angle.
I know we're just gonna stuff the one.
I feel like if you just hit it a little high, you might get all three yellows.
Yeah, all depends on if it catches that red in the top of the button.
Why don't you go look back?
But do you care if your tab really? I mean, it might just drag it. I don't know if it's going to leave it there, or but it, if
as
it
long
even
as they
spins
all go,
out to the eight. Yeah.
Yeah, as long as they all go, you're not real concerned about where your red goes.
I think that's the shot I'm playing all day. Fire it down there, hit it right on the nose. I think they're all going to go, but you're right. If it ticks that red, it could direct it straight back into that yellow and sit on the button, but even if you get it moving and rolling out in the back eight, it's pretty good.
Just the tap, we might line up something here.
There's a pretty sizable spot you can hit on this yellow stone where they should all at least leave the 4 foot.
Yeah, I mean, nose is pretty close.
Yeah.
They probably all go, I think, even if it catches a small piece of that redstone on the top of the button. Peterson's last here in the fifth, playing nose triple.
No, never.
Easy peel.
Didn't like it out of hand. It's going backwards a little bit. Still
gets
them all to go.
Go.
Lined up just right.
Yeah, because it shot it.
That's probably the exact right angle, as they're all gone and didn't move theirs.
Yeah, that was, I was pretty confident those were going if you threw it, because she didn't even really hit it where she wanted to, and it went easy.
Strouse was considering playing for the blank, getting close to the guard for a second, deciding that she's going to draw instead, so needs a bigger piece of the button for one, touch the 4 foot to give up one.
I think so.
This is a big shot in this game.
Yeah. I like this. You got it, Laney. 14-8, 15.
Strouse's final stone, fifth end. Looking for a bigger piece of the pot.
Yeah.
Sweepers like the weight.
Line looks
don't
good.
It.
Looks like it's gliding a little bit. Should turn over right around here.
I got 14-3, so that should be a little heavy.
Got to stay close here.
What a great shot.
Oh, what a great shot by Delaney Strouse. That is one. Big point drawing against two for the young skip. After five ends, score Peterson 4, Strouse 3. And with the fifth end break, it's brought to you by Warm Room Hero, the intuitive curling club software that takes the stress out of schedules, registrations, and more. Warm Room Hero, a platform built for curlers by curlers. Check out Warm Room Hero at curling.club today. So at the fifth end break, Peterson leads Strouse 4-3.
Let's say you're in high school and there's a sport you like. But sometimes you think, you know, it might be cool to try a new sport.
Twin Cities Orthopedics is ready to go with more doctors, specialty services, and convenient urgent care locations. Ready, set, TCO.
There's our live shot in the booth, and I'm sure you recognize this handsome gentleman next to me. Newly crowned national champion, Matthew Hamilton. Make sure you unmute. Perfect. Good to see you, brother. Congratulations again.
Yeah, thanks. It's one of those things. You grind all season, and you find out how hard crewing seasons and how long they last, but it kind of makes it all worth it when you're able to pull this out.
One and a half.
We are starting the six, so
one.
John Landsteiner, it is faster after
one.
The break.
Mine's good. Got a curl.
Matt,
one
we were
half.
Very obviously complimentary of the whole team with the way you guys played in the playoffs, but you know the energy that you brought out there for that 1-2 game in particular, getting your team ready to go.
Halfway.
It's a new tournament. Once you get to the playoffs, always has been for you guys, but you know, speak to that that feeling of it's go time when you get to that 1-2 and for the playoff round.
Yeah, so, I mean, obviously, there's kind of two ways you can go. You can just really embrace the moment and have some fun with it and enjoy yourself, or you can kind of, you know, get a little tight, be nervous, feel the pressure of the everything going on. And one of my goals, as you know, as a player, was make sure everybody on the team is having fun and feeling loose. And fortunately for me, that just means I just have to have a good time, and that typically gets the rest of the guys in a good loose mindset. So,
all right,
it's super important, especially in like games like these. You're the only team, you're the only sheet on the ice. Like if you don't make your own fun, it's not going to happen. So it's sometimes it's manufactured, but most of the time it's pretty natural.
And winning never gets old, Matt. You know, you guys have been there a lot over the last decade now, and. From watching here, it almost looks like it's just another game for you guys, even in the final. The energy that you have out there, the comfort level, you know, for a young team like Danny Casper's squad going up against the reigning champions, the Olympic team, all that. It's a lot of pressure, but for you and for the team, staying in those routines and having it be just another game for you gives you such an advantage going into games like that.
Yeah, again, it's one of those things, like we've played in a lot of these scenarios, fortunately, which is, I feel super fortunate to be able to say that I've got to play in a lot of national championship finals.
Got room.
But it's one of those things, you have team systems, and like it's they're so your team systems for a reason. So you got to like trust trust the kind of game plan you set up and go out there and it's just another game. Like they say, what is that, in Hoosiers, after they get to the national championship, they measure the free throw line and how tall the basket is. And, you know, it might seem like a really large stage, but when you're out there, the curling sheet's the same as the one you practice on, the one that you go to in random Canada or some, you know, place in Europe if you get to play there. So it's all the same. You just kind of got to remind yourself that it's curling. It's no different from any other game you've ever played. It's just you're the feature sheet now.
Matt, talk a little bit about your opponent in that final, too. Danny Casper's squad, Danny and Luke Violette, Ben Richardson, Chase Sinnott. Kind of leapt through a few steps that you expect teams to take to get to that point. You know, they gave you guys a loss in the round robin. You got that win back in the 1-2 and then in the final. But that team, so impressive, and what they brought to the table, that's going to be a threat for years to come now.
Yeah, it's really incredible the jump they've made. And not to say that they were like a team that was a pushover prior to this, but I think that World University Games that they took second in was an absolute perfect warm-up for this, because these guys are used to that long round-robin grind, that playoff mentality where, you know, you either gotta loosen up and feel and just kind of like go out there and play. And this is like their second or third, if you include even the trials for the World University Games, time at playing in these really big moments. And they came out as loose as anyone else. Danny Casper was chirping me before the game, and I loved it because I was just like, okay, that's the kind of game we're having, huh? So, those guys, they play with a lot of confidence. They're super poised. Like, Ben Richardson might be the most poised curler I've ever seen out there on the ice. And, I mean, that first game we played him, Ben ate my lunch. I went hungry that day. So it was nice to be able to play him again and at least hold my own against him. So,
well, Ben's the kind of guy, he'll eat your lunch, and then he'll apologize and make you another lunch, and then eat that lunch too. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's, you know, those guys are so good at curling. And honest, like, between Luke and Chase and obviously Danny Casper, those guys have all played back end, so like that they don't make wrong calls. There was a couple times in that 1-2 game where I'm like, oh, they found the right shot. We're thinking they might play something a little silly or something that you would expect like a young team to play, and they figured it out, and they've got a super bright future. I just hope that I get two more years before these guys really start shining.
So Matt, we put our original team together in 2014. That's been almost 10 years now.
Yeah.
Think back to that point in your curling career and where you are now and everything that's happened since. Multiple national championships, two Olympic berths, obviously getting on top of the podium as well. Could you ever envision that this is where you'd be now, you know, looking back on everything? Has it sunk in at all? Like, just being able to reflect on this past 9 years of an amazing run in the sport?
I just feel super fortunate. Like, obviously, like, you dream of these moments, but, you know, as you get older, you realize not all dreams come true. You can you try your best and give yourself the best situation, but there's other players that want the same thing you do, and there's no guarantees in this game. And I just feel so fortunate that I've had some really great supporting cast around me to carry me along most of this time. And I ain't a light load, so these guys had to carry me quite a bit for the last
lighter than you've been. You slimmed down quite a bit there, Chief.
Really curling now.
Yeah, I wasn't sure Shusti in his old age could still carry me, so I had to trim up a little bit.
Well said. So we do have a interesting end going here with these angles for Team Strouse, Matt. They have two rocks, top fours that are gunned up to that stone in the back of the fours. So Tab may be looking to clear things up.
Yeah, it's the angles like definitely give me that vibe that Tab's a little hooped right now. She needs to make a couple dandies to get out of this end. And I mean, honestly, they should be stoked if they get a point here. And a 2-point lead playing in the sixes, that's massive. Getting that hammer in the even ends. We always started talking about, you don't try that tricky shot for two if you can guarantee yourself one in an even end, because it'll set you up for the future.
Trying to clear as many of these as possible.
Pretty great
hands
shot
on the back. Yellow one just bites on the outside. So much better situation now for Team Peterson, losing one of those stones, pushing it out of the outside, and now that guard is a red stone if they need to play it back again.
So Matt, that transition.
Yeah.
I was just going to mention the transition Corey TC now has made from playing skip to jumping into third. It's super impressive. I always thought, like, once you're skip, you have that mindset, it's tough to move down a position. But she really seems to have bought in, and these girls really seem to gel really well. So I'm impressed with that, this kind of, like, new look, Team Peterson.
Got a curl.
Yeah, and they've spoken so highly of each other as teammates, too, that, you know, Tab has said that Corey coming in, seamless transition, but also having a weapon like that coming in helps so much. On the other side of the coin now, too, with this young team, Strouse. Matt, this team is relentless. Like, it used to be almost reckless with the draw game that they just decided they're going to continue to pile rocks up on you no matter what you had in the house. But they do it smarter now. But at the same time, the aggressiveness with that draw game is what's made this team so successful. And when Peterson got three in the first of this game, I don't think there's anybody in the building that's seen this team play that thought this game was over.
Absolutely not, and I'm sure after you watch the way Strouse calls these games, it's a little reminiscent of our squad. The best way to attack is just put another good shot in there. So these girls are absolute studs. I am super impressed and looking forward to what USA Curling has to offer these girls, because Team Strouse is definitely going to be a contender for a long time if they want to be.
And Matt, before we let you go, World Championships are in Ottawa this year. Any Worlds in Canada is always a blast. We know that. Crowds will be hot. Patch will be hopping. Talk about the excitement of playing, and we're seeing it a little bit here with this crowd too, and a lot of fresh curling faces that people maybe don't know as much about the sport, but you know, the energy in the building is going to be electric for an event like that. I know that lifts you in particular up, but for the entire team, it seems as though you still feed off of that type of energy and that type of crowd. Talk about how fun that event is going to be. Maybe get people excited about possibly going up and supporting Team USA at the championships.
I mean, it's pretty awesome when you're in an arena of a bunch of people that have a pretty good idea what's going on. Like, a lot of times people are just curious in curling in the U.S. and they come show up, they're like, hey, I saw this on TV, but never tried it, never really played it. And that's great. We're super stoked to have them come out. But sometimes you get these Canadian fans and they all know what's going on and they all have their opinions on what shots should be thrown and what shouldn't be thrown. And as you remember, my first time at the World Championships, we went up against Pat Simmons on an end sheet in Canada. And
wild
I was
game.
Heckled ruthlessly that game. So there's definitely pros and cons to playing in Canada. When you're not playing the Canadian team, it's not so bad. But when you're playing against Canada, they can be a ruthless group of fans out there. So it's definitely, the energy's great. And, you know, I'd rather have some ruthless fans than no fans at all. So
I agree
with
that.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
So that role for Team Strouse creates a little bit of a pocket. Tab and Corey discussing, looked like they called the freeze right away, and now they talked it out a little more and coming back to the same shot. Not a great leave from Delaney Strouse's first, and this possibly brings a cheap two back into the picture for Tab.
Yeah, good freeze here. If you can just get that angle just right, you got to get to nose of that one on the center line or just a shade across it, and you're looking pretty good to get your at least an opportunity for two. Delaney will still probably have a freeze out of her own. If she makes it really perfect, it could still force one. But yeah, little bit of a miss on that last one rolling in instead of out.
Tab Peterson's first here in the sixth. Trying to get all the way down to this pocket. Don't want to move those stones around too much, so that stone can't be unlocked. Very important draw for Tab now. Sweepers seem to like it.
Tara's going. Becca thought it was pretty close, but Tara has not picked her head up for the last half the sheet.
Still going, trying to get as close as they can, but there will be a little bit of space. Strouse will be able to get that out if she hits the right angle. And Matt, I believe I'm probably helping you out a little bit here. You have the mic. You're on the air. Your wife's listening.
Just watch the
I guarantee that. She should probably say hi. She's back at home. She's been texting, nervous, watching too, and cheering you on like crazy.
Yeah, Jen's super fan. Doesn't matter if I'm on the ice or not. As long as Hamilton's on the sheet, she's definitely into the game. And she's come a long way with her strategy. She talked to me about a couple shots and when we were watching that Casper Dropkin game last night. And she's pretty spot on. I'm pretty impressed with how much curling she's picked up for how little I want to talk about it when I'm at home.
Well, maybe she'll start her curling career now and expect you to stay at home instead. We'll see.
I told her I got a mixed doubles partner already. Sorry, babe.
Delaney Strouse's final stone of this six, trying to peel this over the top. Looks like he'll have no problem.
Pistol of a shot.
Well done by Strouse. Peterson will have the same draw for her one.
Great great force setup. Obviously, if something goes wrong, Strouse can get a little bit of a mittful here, but the real goal, force Peterson to one, get your deuce there in seven, and then you're playing eight, three end game, tied up. Can't complain with those results.
Yeah, you just have a feeling that this is going to the wire with these two teams. It's the only way that this should finish. So Tab's final stone, sixth end. Drawing to the 4 foot for 1 point. Sweeper's off this one early. This is the straighter side too. This is running a little bit, Matt.
Yeah. I would definitely be trying to carve this one if I thought it was close.
Yeah, this may end up going by. It's really close. Spills off.
Deal of... Oh, man. I don't want to make a call here. It kind of looks like that yellow closer to the center line is one, and then the red is out counting the one on the far right. So it kind of looks like a steal of one.
I'm going to go with red for one right now.
But you know, the overheads I hate to bet against my sister. I'm betting on. I'm gonna say it's one yellow.
They pushed one out already. Not sure what they're calling on that one as of yet, but I think they're gonna spin the sticks on this one.
Do you ever wish that, as a player, that you could just be the one spinning the measuring stick instead of watching the official do it?
No. I'm just fine with them doing it. I don't want to step in on that and make the mistake and do it wrong.
Ah, that's fair.
At least we can blame somebody else if it's the official that makes the mistake.
That's a good point. My thought, especially still competing, it's like I measure rocks all year for, you know, both teams. Like the other team will measure them, I'll measure them. Like we all know how to do it. Sometimes I feel like the officials, you get players who will ask for second measures and third measures and just gets a little bit too much.
So, Matt, they pushed that other yellow stone out first. I thought that yellow one was at least closer than the other yellow.
Oh, so, you thought that winger was. Well, Tyler, you know that you guys brought me in to look at who was closer. That was like my role on the team. So
eagle eye it.
I'm going to say it's yellow here. That's my bet.
Do you think that other yellow was shot first?
No, I thought that one was
okay,
third.
Okay, so you think this
sure.
is a measure for one. We do not know. We didn't hear on the mics if there was a point called or if this is for one.
Sorry, Jen, but I'm betting my house that one is definitely out. Ooh, looks like it might have been red. That looks like red on the screen to me.
So many. This is really close, too. I think they're going to measure again. They actually pointed yellow.
It looked like red moved a little farther on that
dial.
Let's
pay close attention to this needle here if we get a chance. Not the best angle to see. There, she moved away for us. So that goes to halfway past that, well, whatever number that is.
Just short of it.
Yeah, that's yellow.
Called it.
Wow. Hamilton with the call. Takes me down again, folks. Just can't beat the guy. He can't lose today. Matt, thanks so much for joining, man. Congratulations again. And, you know, for myself and for the U.S. curling world, thanks for all you guys are doing to promote sports and represent us well. And we wish you the best of luck in Ottawa, man.
Yeah, I appreciate that, Tyler, and take this chance to say thanks to everybody who did tune in and watched. Obviously, curling is growing here, and, you know, we might not be everyone's favorite team, but we do appreciate everyone who does watch and tune in because it helps curling as a whole, whether, you know, it was you're cheering for Strouse or Dropkin, Dunham or Schuster. It was definitely a big bonus for all of us to have you people, so I appreciate it.
All right, thanks again, Matt. We will move on to the sixth inning. We still aren't sure how many points were scored, but we'll let you know when we come back from the break.
Just because you're not a professional athlete doesn't mean that you should accept less. The beauty about what Thorn does is our product quality is the same whether they're in the athletic line or whether they're just for the everyday person. Thorn has kept true to never compromising on quality, never compromising on efficacy, never compromising on safety for not only athletes but for everyone who would use their products.
Beginning of the seventh end, this 2023 USA Curling Women's National Championship game. It is a steal of one for Team Strouse. Score now tied 4-4 at the start of the seventh. Thanks to our friends at Floor Curl, USA Curling member clubs are entitled to a 20% discount on any Floor Curl inflatable rink set. These rinks only take a minute to inflate or deflate, are the perfect way to promote your club. At summer festivals, events, or anywhere you have a flat surface, no ice required. Visit usacurling.floorcurl.com. Use the promo code FCInflatable20. That's usacurling.floorcurl.com. Promo code FCInflatable20. Thanks again, Chad McMullen, Steph and Ryan LeDrew for supporting.
Eight.
Rich, 4-4 now, as we expected this game.
Seven.
Probably coming to the wire.
Seven.
Team Strouse.
Eight.
No quitting these ladies after giving up a three in the first.
If we go.
They've only given up 1 point since.
Gotta go.
Score now tied 4-4.
Yeah, big steal there, and they needed that to get back in. Now it's anybody's game. You know, you're looking to try to get a force here in seven and get your two, and we were talking about trading two for ones. You don't need to if you steal one, and that's what they just did. So by a measurement, so really important steal for them, and now that we're going to have a barn burner here.
Rebecca Rogers comes around to the top of the button. This is a 0-2 end for Team Peterson, Rich. You don't want to get caught in between. Once you see how the rocks are setting up, then usually you make that decision if you're going full bore for the multiple point end or if you're trying to keep things clean. For the time being, looks like Peterson's content to mix it up a little bit.
Yeah, I think if you know, a blank here in the seventh is a great result. If you are the team with the hammer in a tied game, it probably increases your chances of winning by about 10 or 15% to get to eight, because then if you score an eight, you're good. You're in better shape, I would say. So I don't think Tab wants to do anything too crazy, maybe bail out and still have a chance at the blank, but you're right. If you get it, anytime you can get a two, you take it.
Don't push, Anna. Straight.
Playing to a freeze tap.
Good, straight though.
High ball.
Take a look.
You don't want to roll off here. Oh, she went right around.
Ends up going by and sitting third count, I believe, in the back of the 8 foot. So not a terrible result.
Like one more in there?
If Peterson does play the come around freeze, Rich, to that rock that they just threw, then they're pretty much conceding that they're going for 2 points this end.
Yep.
Sounds
like her front end really wants to peel.
I also don't mind this.
I don't mind either. It's all about your mindset and what you're trying to accomplish. You know, if you're thinking that you like your chances of blanking more and your numbers as a team play into that strategy, then that's the right shot. And if you think that trying to score two and being more aggressive here puts you in a better chance to win, then that's the right shot. So this is not a correct or wrong call. It's just a team preference or team analysis shot where you know where your team is strongest. So they do play the peel, perfectly made by Becca Hamilton.
You like freezing on top?
So now Delaney's calling the freeze right on top of this red, and I think the guard is not a bad call here. She's gonna peel. What you want the other team to do is waste some shots here, because you're sitting with shot, but they're right on top of you. You're not in perfect shape, but I think if you throw a guard, they'll peel again.
You like the tap over just the freeze?
But she's, and you put it on you play this freeze here, and you don't get it exactly on the nose, and it's everything's gonna be gone in a second, right?
Yeah. I don't need a 15.
Yeah, and this is a top 8 here. Strategy play too, or tactics play, where you're same as Team Peterson had with that peel, either the freeze or the guard. If you're playing it into the house, you're playing a little more conservative. If you're playing the guard, then you're still playing for the force or the steal a little bit more.
Let it work.
The problem though with coming into the house here is they will then hit you, and they'll leave another one of their rocks laying around, right? So whereas if it's a guard and they play it, they can't have that rock count, right? But it turned out to be a really good freeze. But now I'm just going to play this light and keep my shooter around, keep that red around, you know. They play this with just board weight, or maybe a little bit more control, leave their shooter, the one yellow's gone, and now you got three reds in the house.
That's fine, but then they're probably shot.
There is an opportunity to try to play this really open now too. If you throw peel at that top yellow one, hit maybe a third of that stone, shoot the red back into the yellow, you could lose as many as three of those stones and still keep that red rock top fours, and then your blank is back in play. Looks like they're still playing just to stick around here.
I kind of like sticking around. I understand what you're saying. You're probably getting rid of three or four rocks, and you know, maybe you have it, but if you can keep the shooter around, I think it's big.
Angles don't play out that well on that from Peterson. Still lined up to that red rock on the button.
What's welded here? I like 15.
I believe they're calling the freeze here, Rich. This is a dangerous shot. If this welds on the outside of that stone, you could see all three of those yellows go. I don't think they're looking real closely at the angles on this shot.
I agree. Even if you make a good freeze, you're actually making it so you can keep the red around by freezing here.
Right.
Okay. Five. Straight then.
I mean, I don't know what else you do other than you hit those top two, probably, and to get rid of both reds.
Yeah,
it's not
I
a
think
bad
you could
call.
Play the outturn draw around.
Yeah, you could
two.
Do that.
Five. Four points.
This over curling, and that may not be a bad thing for Team Strouse.
Bounce it off. Straight. Ooh. Bounce it off.
Okay.
I mean, they have this.
I think you left enough to get the double on the yellows, don't you? Maybe.
Yeah, there's some space.
It looks like there's room.
They could definitely lose both of those yellows and still keep the shooter.
You could probably make that.
That's what I like.
Okay.
Yeah, Tab, it's not a probably you can make that. You can definitely make that.
9-5.
Only playing 9-5. They want to keep the shooter around, so just normal hit. Corey TC's first, seventh end.
Whoa! Back
up! Tab didn't like the release. Calling to turn it over. Most important is keeping the shooter here.
Close. Good.
She did actually just graze that yellow and set it up a little worse for the angle.
Strouse again calling for a freeze.
Wait on a 15-5 on that.
Again, same thing. I'm not real happy about this angle if you're playing the freeze for Strouse. Now with that other rock on the wing, you know, you set this on the wrong spot. This could be red sitting four afterwards if the angles play out right.
Seven.
Yeah, I think you got to be careful here. I would have maybe even been tempted to just play the off the one on the left there and roll in for now. Because even if you make this really good, which she looks like she might, the angle might be bad.
Well, if you make it that good, it's not so bad.
Yeah.
Now that yellow one looks like it's probably staying. You had to get so close to that yellow stone in the top of the forefoot to get to that angle, but it appears as though they did.
I think if you throw this hard, I think both yellows are gone, but your red is gone too, and you're rolling out probably.
yeah, it's the angle still plays well for this shot for TC. We'll see how many go. Just the one.
Good, Corey.
Looks she kept hers around. Just maybe one for Strouse right now?
I think so. I think it's just the one in the back. But you left another red one around, and you got a double in the back if you need it. So.
Yeah, and you have a stopper rock over there, too, to roll away.
And you can't really double the other ones without sending them into our
own. Watch the jam, Anna. You got to hit it.
It's a lot of broom for this shot, too, Rich. I know this is the swingier turn, but.
Yeah. As long as we have a piece of the eight, we're really good.
Just fine with using those rocks to stop, but.
Yep.
You don't want to be thin.
Yep.
Go behind those two reds and then leave a double to sit three.
10-5.
Seems like a lot of broom for 10-5.
Yeah. Yeah. I'd be a little concerned about the broom for that eight.
10!
But looks to be okay. Sweeping on and off.
10!
Whoa!
Looks like it's hanging a little. Good shot.
That's pretty well done. Sitting three. Peterson now forced to freeze as the blank is pretty much out the window with five rocks in and three rocks to throw. So really nice shot there by Delaney Strouse. And Rich, I feel like the number of times that I've questioned Delaney's broom or decisions have been on the wrong side for me throughout this week. That's apparently that broom was perfect and the weight was perfect.
Yeah,
why we're up here.
She threw that well, for sure.
Yeah,
and it did
really
curl a little there. Looked like she had good weight. And so Tab's got to make a decision here. She could just play this double and put the pressure on Delaney to have two rocks somewhere in the house closer than the three reds. You know, if she just runs this straight back, makes the double, rolls a little, it makes Delaney have to hit and stay or throw another rock in the house somewhere. So,
I think she'd have to draw because if they knows, if Tab only rolled a half a foot and Delaney knows, she may not outcount those redstones in the 12 foot with a nose hit.
Yeah, she was originally talking about just freezing down on the one on the left here off the 4 foot, but she's changed her mind now. She's going to throw the hit. I kind of like the call because you're not in really any danger of a steal. And if you make this double, then they got to be super careful. One miss and you could get a three or a four. So I kind of like this call.
Yeah, I agree. This is the one that puts a little more pressure on Delaney for a big end. So Peterson playing the outturn double. Nose would be good enough. Maybe a little inside nose.
Whoa! Whoa! Yes!
Took a little turn right there. Boy, over curls.
Oof.
That's going to roll out. So got a little surprised by the ice there.
You know, and we talked about this earlier, Ty. That's that spot where you're just outside that straight spot, right on the edge of the eight, and we had that happen to us and made us look silly a few times this weekend. You know, right there is about the spot that it will curl, and if you're in 3 inches, it's not curling at all. So I think they got kind of caught by that spot, and that happened to a lot of us this week.
Yeah, we had to go.
Rich, maybe top eight here.
Yeah, 15-2.
And make Peterson draw.
Yeah, I agree. Just get in for third.
Against the 3 points.
Yep, she needs to bring this in the house, though, because if she is short or isn't out counting those two reds, there's a double for three. So this has got to be at least full eight, touching eight anyway.
And if I'm Strouse, I want to leave this maybe just staggered a hair on the side of the center line they're on and make Peterson play that swing turn into that line.
Biting top eight.
Don't want to be
exactly
any deeper than 8 foot. Needs this to stop so there's no nose hit.
Sorry.
And ends up going deep enough. That's very close to. I'm not sure she can nose and get shots.
That might be
apologizing,
perfect.
But that might be really good.
that
2 inches shorter
perfect.
And it's perfect, but still really good.
I think if she noses it, she might. Well, the back one will out counter, but you're probably going to hit it if you nose it, right? She's got to be careful here.
Yeah, if you make the double, you're scoring. It looks like.
And here's the problem here. You get a little anxious and you sweep it to make the double and you roll a little too far and you could give up a steal a two in a hurry here.
Yeah, there's not a lot of margin for error. And you heard Tab say she's throwing 9-5, so they're not overthrowing this. But yeah, I think it will obviously a nose dead sticks and you're giving up a steal a one, but you have to be very careful. Starting to turn. Really curling hard now. Gotta go.
Made it.
Oh, and makes the double
nice
for
shot.
One. Great shot by
That's
Peterson.
That's a pistol.
So they do secure the 1 point with that double by Tab. Now after seven ends of play, Peterson leads Strouse 5-4. On to the eighth end, this women's USA Curling National Championship game. Peterson leading Strouse 5-4 with the start of the eighth end. One last time. Warm Room Hero is more than just software. It's run by curlers dedicated to building long-term relationships with your club. Warm Room Hero provides continuous support to ensure your website exceeds your members' expectations. Check out Warm Room Hero today at curling.club. for special event pricing. Thanks again to Anthony D'Arco, Windy City Curling Club in Chicago, for supporting the Nationals in the event. And thanks to Curling Stadium for being a part of this championship and moving forward with the coverage that they'll be supplying for national level events, World Tour events, international events. Their setup is available to put into curling clubs as well. If you want to show your league games, your Bonspiels, anything like that. But it's been really fun being a part of this crew. And thank John Benton, Joel Dietz, Cameron Rittenauer, Jerry Gertz for being a part of this system. Looking forward to working with them more in the future. Maybe just not doing quite so many games in the future for me, though, Rich.
Yes. You've definitely put in your time this week. Thank you, too, for doing that.
Yeah,
bring it to our fans and our friends and our family that couldn't make it here.
Yeah, just despite the long week, it is a lot of fun.
Line's good.
I really enjoy being a part of these events still and in some way, shape, or form. And it's kind of like sitting on your couch at home with friends, except there's a few thousand of them with you talking about the game and getting to share this with everybody. And we do have a fantastic final here, as we expected. These two teams have gone at each other for almost three full games now and been nip and tuck the entire way.
Six.
Strouse now down one with Hammer in the eighth end. Berth at the World Championships on the line.
It's got a snap.
Trying to do what nobody else has been able to do this week. Put a loss on Tab Peterson.
Okay. It's good, Bex. Real
Pretty good.
Good
spot there in the top eight. A little bit of a teaser, Rich.
Yeah, she got it got it around. It's in good. It's in a pretty good spot. They got to be really careful here because you don't want to give a deuce here if you are Peterson. You want to be in control, either tied or tied with, and going into nine here. So this is a big end. I mean, this is the eighth end, the home end, and you really need to make a move here if you're Strouse and try to get a deuce.
Careful. Line's good. Right on it, ladies.
And for Team Strouse, you want to score regardless in this end, so you're comfortable going hard at getting two because you have no problem with getting forced playing a two-end game where you probably get hammer and a 10.
On the inside.
On the inside's better.
And I'm sure Coach Benson has
what are you thinking?
Spoken with them, worked with them on what situation they want to put themselves in, too, with whether they'd rather be up one without or down one with if it comes to it.
That's what I was thinking. You should have all of it, yeah?
And this, Becca Hamilton's rock did not curl enough, and so this leaves a nose double. Both the reds will be gone if she hits this on the nose, and yellow will be laying three. So big shot here.
Yeah, I like hitting here too, Rich, because, again, you do want to secure that one point end regardless. This looks like it needs to curl a little bit. Spills it to the open.
Good.
Pretty good result. Still early enough in the end. You're not real concerned about sitting three. And with this double, you have to catch it kind of thin on the rock in the top of the fours to avoid jamming on your own stone on the side.
I might be tempted just to play the run here, Ty.
Yeah, and she's looking at that now, too.
Because, I mean, you could get yourself in bad shape here if you run that into it and roll it into the red. So I think the run's a good call here. You just nose it, and you might get both yellows off, or two of the three yellows off.
I'm starting to get a little nervous now watching this. Huh? This is fun.
It's
stuff.
Exciting.
Whoa! Yep! 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 It's good.
Ooh, just papers by on that. Yellow sitting one and three, and.
Do we want to roll in or no?
Yeah, that's. What do you think, Rich?
Nose.
You want to just nose here, right?
Yeah, I think you
force
don't want
to make that short little run.
Nice and easy.
Yeah, she's calling the roll, but I think nosing is really good. That rocks.
Well, I think they changed it. I think they said just nose now.
Okay. Yeah, you want to stay right there. I don't think you want to roll in. You don't want to give Tab any outs right now.
Clean.
You're clean from Delaney Strouse. Just needs to sit full 12s to be count.
Straight. Whoa. Good.
Actually does roll all the way into the forefoot. If you're going to roll, that's a pretty good spot to go to.
Now I still think I'm playing the center red on the line, yeah.
I just am worried we roll our shooter out with that guy.
Some good shot making going on right now.
You wanna
Team Strouse not faltering here late so far. This. Team has ice water in their veins right now. And Rich, that 1-2 game going the way it did and then coming back and winning the next one, you know, that mental edge you have from knowing, okay, we can handle anything. You know, they're not thinking about the collapse. They're thinking about how they came back from it, or hopefully.
We never had it.
And that ends up crossing, though, for Team Peterson. And this is getting a little interesting now for Delaney Strouse trying to figure out how to map this out, and I don't think there's a triple there, Rich.
I don't either.
Like
I think
unless
you're okay,
you slash over the top.
I like it.
Okay,
so
perfect.
I think drawing to the wing here is a good call. Put
I think
another
it's a
one
great
in.
Call.
You got it, Anna. Let's get a good one here.
Very smart play by Strouse, not overcomplicating things in the middle. And here's one too, Rich, where you can play this out and basically dare Tab to make that run or that tap
hey,
or that tap
girls.
Saying. We're fine with taking our one if it comes to it,
room.
But we're going to take a chance at winning this game right now by putting another one in the rings. And those shots tighten up a lot when you're playing against a possible three or four in this situation. This one needs to hit the brakes. Nothing wrong with back eights if it stops there. That'll be just fine. That's a really good spot.
It's really good.
That's perfect, actually.
Tab's going to need to have a couple of doubles in a row here to get out of trouble. So.
Yeah, but I like the decision. I like, no guards in play is fine. There's no real steal looming here. So basically you're in kind of a one two, three, four situation.
Yep.
Where there's no bad outcome for Team Strouse.
Yep.
TC with the out turn. Run in, trying to clear as many as they can.
Hard! Hard!
Oh, she got two of them out. That's a good shot.
That's a great result there.
You think anything happened?
Looks like the rock hit Tara's foot or something, so they don't know how far it was going to roll.
Gonna go in it. Oh, okay, then we'll just put it.
So they just put it back. Both teams just say, hey, this is what I think happened, and they're both fine with it.
Oh, let's just play. They ran our clock, but we're good. Okay.
I think it's a bait, Anna.
That actually ended up being a pretty good shot because she got two of them out of there, moved around a little bit, and she's got a little run here on the left for her next shot probably that will be fine for her. So Strouse is just going to draw out turn. Well, not for Anna. She's a lefty.
Yep. No, I've made that mistake plenty of times with the number of lefties in this field. So Rich, you throw this right to the tee maybe?
I think
calling 3-4 out of hand.
Yeah, you need to get it for sure. I don't know about all the way to the tee, but just short. Okay. But you don't want to leave a double on the two yellows side by side. She looks really light.
Not going to get anywhere near the paint now, so. Door opens up again.
Okay, Anna, your line was really good.
For Peterson.
No worries.
So, yep, I think nose is really good.
Short little run here that could either stay under the shooter or roll under the two on the corner, so.
This is what Tab needed to get out. Is she needed a miss here to get out of trouble. And now if she even hits this right on the nose, she's in front of it. They're going to probably have to hit it back and not be in the house, right? So I think this is, even if you just stuff this, you're still sitting in pretty good shape.
Yeah, ill-timed mistake there from Team Strouse. Now flip the script for Team Peterson with this short little run. Couple of different options to get something good out of this too.
Yeah, you might hit this and roll it in behind those two guards too, top four. So whatever you got to do is you got to make contact.
Should get a little bit of a turn on this line. That will roll off, so a little bit of an error there from Peterson too. Door open again for Delaney. Rich, you ever think about just throwing this to open back eight? Stay away from the short little run for Tab? Or are you okay with her playing that run?
I think you got to let her play it. You know, if you go back eight and Tab decides to gamble and draw, you could give up a steal here. So you're sitting really good for two. I think you just draw around top eight here.
I like this line in this call, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Show half, probably ideal.
How deep? Top eight?
Yeah, I like just top eight, like half buried if we can.
Sounds
yeah,
good,
like
Delaney.
It might stay a little straight.
Yeah, she must have heard you.
Yeah.
You guys like the ice? Maybe like a little less.
Well, if she's agreeing with me, then I'm probably right because she's been right most of this week. Outturn draw for Delaney Strouse, trying to come around to the top of the 8 foot. Possibly set up a 2 or 3 point end. It's all important eighth. Going six. Six would be all right. They don't want it deeper than that.
Really going sideways. Straight. No, straight.
Oh, just papers by.
Papered it by.
To the top of the fours. Bites the button.
So that's a good shot, but here's the problem. It came a little deep, and now Tab can freeze her out of the back point, and it's going to be tough to get to.
Yeah, this is a high pressure freeze for Tab. Could even tap it a little bit to try to get count, but you don't want to bump off. It has to be the right line if you're going to play that.
You bump off and you give up three in a hurry. So this is a big shot in this game right now because she makes this. It's probably no way for Delaney to get two.
And Rich, this line too, you've seen this. Once it gets inside the edge of the 8 foot, this will turn over hard. It may not go early, but when it goes, it's going to curl a lot on this turn.
Okay. And so, that biter on the top 12 can get in the way sometimes on these, where it hangs for a little and then it goes. But yeah, she needs a freeze right here. It was a big shot in this game.
Tab Peterson's last here in the eighth, playing the freeze. Thought the line might have been a little tight out of hand. Sweepers just clean.
They're
it
not
for
on
now.
It though.
Line's good. On it. Line's
now turning over hard.
No bump. No bump. Right.
Looks pretty good. Over curling a little bit.
What a shot.
Great freeze.
Pressure shot right there by Tab Peterson.
So is there any kind of shot following down, chip off that red, Rich? I think you can.
I think you can too.
Back eight type of weight and just touch that, move over.
But problem is, you got to be careful, because if you overcurl, then you give him one if you throw it too hard. If you're throwing back eight, you know. Now you have to move two rocks, so you're probably not bumping it out of the 4 foot, but you got to be careful here.
I'm kind of feeling this, I'm not going to lie.
I think she can get there all the way around the outside, and it is there. You don't have to get that tight to that redstone to make it, so just walk this into the side of the four, and you play it to the back 4 foot, so it's curling on that line.
Yep. Over there.
Someone told me to shut up when I yell.
Yeah, it's
you
rude.
Also? Yeah, okay.
Dude. I mean, we can go through the port. I just really
all right, so she's
going to
go way out wide here. Now, what we found is we made a few mistakes this week, and some teams we played against that it really isn't slower out here late in the game. You think maybe it's just sometimes you haven't been out that wide and it's a little slower, and it really isn't at all.
I think I would have been tempted to play the rub off, even though it curls a lot on that line, just playing it with a little more weight. But Delaney liked this one from the start, so you know, you want to play what the skip likes. Get an aggressive line at it. It's a final stone, eighth end. Delaney Strouse trying to draw the side of the 4 foot for a second point. Really curling now, needs this goal to get by. Oh, just wrecks. Looked
perfect
like the
weight.
Was really close, too. So it is just a single after that great freeze by Tab Peterson to get out of the end. On to the ninth. Peterson Strouse tied at 5.
Twin Cities Orthopedics is ready to go with more doctors, specialty services, and convenient urgent care locations. Ready, set, TCO.
Ninth end, 2023 USA Curling Women's National Championship game. Tabitha Peterson, Delaney Strouse tied at 5.
A little.
Peterson with hammer here in the ninth. And Rich, that freeze by Tab Peterson, maybe a game saver, forcing Strouse to 1 point.
Yeah, you know, you can't underestimate that shot. I mean, that was not easy. And she put it right on it, froze it, and made it hard for Delaney to get her two. And, you know, just needed a little more ice on that last shot probably, and perfect weight, but she only gets one. And that's a big swing in a game like this. I mean, that flips the odds. If she gets two, she's probably 60% to win, you know, and now it's the other way probably. 70, more like 70 for Tab now based on, you know, overall teams. And obviously it does matter what team you're playing, and you know, but generally you got pretty good chance to win now if you're in the ninth tied with.
We got a freeze.
And now for Team Strouse, Rich, the number one goal, no matter what, is make somebody score.
It'll warp in.
You do not want a blank end and have to steal in the 10th to win. So see them really push the action here. This will probably be just trying to throw it to a
seven.
Well, I was expecting maybe a tight guard, but it looks like they're actually coming in with a freeze.
Yeah, it's a pretty high guard, so I'm, you know, maybe the shot is to throw up two guards here, but if you get a good freeze here, you're still in good shape too right away.
Whoa.
And it looks pretty good.
Good back.
Freeze is made. But yeah, the with that guard being as high as it is, you can dig just about anything out 8 foot or deeper. And for Delaney, you know, again, you need a rock and play that you can use to make sure that somebody has to score. And that high guard is helpful, but not as much as a tight one. They didn't want to be chasing two stones under the centers. So that's why they played the freeze. But again, you have to try to avoid that blank attempt at all costs. Either team scoring one is not a terrible result for Strouse, but the worst case scenario is the blank. Peterson obviously scoring multiple points would be.
I was just going to say that would be probably the worst case scenario. But.
That would be, yeah. I mean, like five probably would be bad.
But you're right. When that guard doesn't come, when you're this high, you can get around anything. You can make a hit and hit half of a rock, even if it's totally buried when it's that high. So.
Overcurling by a lot.
Tara Peterson's freeze thrown well, but Mulaney's really trying to get this by the guard. If this ends up being in the top of the house underneath that, that's not so bad. You said overcurling by a lot. Doesn't look like it.
So I think we're peeling if we're tab right now, I would think. Yeah, it looks like that's what they're talking about. The angles aren't terrible for her right now.
So Becca playing the peel immediately.
This is one of those situations where you might just keep throwing a guard and having it peeled off, and then Delaney's going to have to be the one to make the first move, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, the angles don't play out real well right now for Strouse.
At least the two, I think.
But re-guarding and making Peterson waste a few shots before you do anything is important. The last thing you want now is to be trading hits in the house with no guards this early in the end, giving Peterson a chance to clean things up. So we'll see at least one more guard after this, possibly two.
Really,
I think I'd be tempted to guard right up until Skip's first if I'm Strouse. This turning over now, they need it to stop.
Yeah, this is curling.
It is covering the right side of the stone, though.
Yeah.
That's.
I think you're still going to peel here.
I think you need to peel still if you're tab.
Yeah.
I like the peel here, Ty, because I think you just like we talked about, you make Strouse make the first move. And she's not peeling, though. Looks like she's going to play some sort of little tap.
Yeah, just playing it soft, too, which I thought if they played something in, they'd play it with weight, try to lose something.
Yeah, you need to try to lose something. You want to keep the blank alive, too.
Yeah, this tells you that tab is just fine with playing aggressive to try to score two or more.
Keep going.
This really hanging out.
Wrong side.
Okay, fine. Yep, Tara. Yep.
Now the angle's playing a little bit better for Team Strouse, so not the greatest result.
How much of this do you have?
Less than half.
I like almost like a tap on this and move that red stone behind your own yellow, Rich.
Yes.
We could freeze it.
You could do that, or you could just tap this yellow that's right in the center and not really want to move everything. Just bump it up a foot straight in line. It's not a bad call either, I think.
Yeah, I don't want to tap it to the pocket because then they might be able to slash the red and lose a few.
Do we ever freeze to this one?
Yeah, I like that outturn tap, just red, red.
Potentially you can get enough of it.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to kill it, though, on that line.
Just hit what we can.
Well, you really want your shooter to stick around if you're going to do this. But it looks like with that broom that they're just playing some kind of hacked through the house type of weight.
I mean, if she can get to nose here, close to nose, where it rolls right with it, and she's on top of it. It's pretty, pretty good.
Otto O'Hara's first of the night.
12! 12 straight! 12! Straight! 12! 12!
12, 12, so that's quite straight. A bit more weight than they were 12, playing for. Whoa. Really curling straight. Now, though.
Yep, 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 hard.
Pretty good
yep,
shot.
Hard.
Not bad.
Hard, Laney, hard.
Good, Anna.
Angles are pretty good. I really like where that shooter ended up with that angle on the
or we could just use
red
this.
Stone.
Is the triple there, Ty?
What's that?
Is the triple there? Top, you know, a third of the front yellow there right by Corey's feet.
You know, it's real thin to get to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Probably is a little thin. You could probably end up stacking it on your own red there too, right?
Yeah, it's really close to if it misses that stone, it'll hit the red, probably go back into the other yellow.
And even if we like I said before, like kind
of
over.
You got to get one of those yellows out of there right now, I think.
Interesting end.
Four? Is that enough?
That was a really good shot, actually. I mean, it just made
yeah, good
the
result.
Angles are a lot better now.
Corey Tesey's first of this ninth end. In turn, playing that top yellow back. Looked a little soft on the release, but straight side. Shouldn't curl as much. Peterson trying to get this to turn over.
Didn't get any of them out of the forefoot.
Interesting. Again.
How much of this yellow do you have, Anna? The yellow do you have?
Top berries? Or we can be top four even.
What are you thinking, Becca?
What do you like here, Tom? Do you ever just bump that yellow a little bit? Try to get on, get to nose?
I was looking at that, yeah. I think Delaney's just playing the intern round,
right.
Which will allow Tab to play her
yeah,
stone 15. Up.
I don't think we're getting a blank here.
Unlikely. So outturn draw from lefty Anna O'Hara. Just trying to get to at least top 8 foot, top four maybe. Heard 7-8.
Like this is starting to curl.
Line's holding for now. Now
Eight.
It's taking a turn. Weight's coming off it a little bit too. Got to go for line.
Any rub, any bounce. Yeah.
That's the second time that stone from O'Hara's overcurled and maybe dug a little bit. That happened in the previous end too. I always like to give the player the benefit.
What?
Blame the rock.
Clip this way, but it might also just take it out.
Well, if you could ever just make the double on the two yellows on the left, you're not sitting horrible, but you know, maybe you play the top two, the yellow, yep, into the red right there and over.
Or do you like getting rid of one of the shot stones?
I mean, I wonder if you can hit the crotch of these two, the red and the yellow, and push the yellow over the top and sit there.
This double.
She's decided to play the double that I originally talked about, it looks like.
What?
That's what I if we could, if she does hit the inside half of this yellow, hit into this red, and push that yellow over.
You like it this way?
And she's lined up on both sides to,
that's fine too.
To get that one off the pot later.
Yeah, really important to have the shooter stay around
yes.
here unless you're kicking something over rolling in. And removing that rock, biting the forefoot
yep.
would turn this end around again.
Whoa. Yep. Hard. Whoa. Yep.
There's that double.
Great shot.
Really good.
See, now she's got her both ways here. She can hit that red one in to get the point, and she's Well, maybe hooked yourself
a little
bit.
Still only playing for one, though, too.
Yep.
But I don't know. I was like, I feel like, yeah.
You don't want to move that yellow stone right now. That rock is helping your angles a lot.
Yeah. I feel like the hit and roll is
just throwing an intern draw around, but this is a little dangerous too with the red stone just to the left of the center line. Could possibly play it back into a raised double. So, Rich, I think you probably want
to
leave this top four. You need to bury so that she doesn't have the slash. But if you can leave it top four, maybe three quarters buried.
All right, you got it.
Might make that run a little bit tougher at least.
14-7.
Yeah, if you bring it too deep here, then it's the easy straight back double and they could be lane two. So it's a big shot here. She needs to just probably touch four, a little bit inside of touching four. And
we got to go.
Sweeper's going on this hard early.
I think you gotta go.
Looks like this is dying and over
curling. Hey, guard the run! Guard the run! Curl it! Hard!
Whoa! I don't want to freeze it and line it up, but does make that run a little longer. Not a terrible result.
She looks like it's kind of lined up. They're looking at playing this straight back to tick that one out.
Yeah, and if they... they can stick this.
Is the double there on the right?
It's close. I think this shot's probably a better shot.
Yeah.
But that may come into play for the last stone. So Peterson playing the double run. Yellow, red, yellow to the number one counter on the back of the button. Tab calling bad slide on herself, but result is all that counts.
Got it.
Pick that rock out, but rolls out. Still only sitting one.
I mean,
so a good opportunity now for Strouse. If she can make this intern draw, she's probably either scoring one or giving up one with where this line up, unless that double that you talked about is there, Rich.
That was a really good shot, but you knew even if without staying there, you're going to leave her this draw to maybe steal here. So, a great shot by Tab and. She's getting old enough now to be an artist. You know, she had a little bad slide there, but you know, we all kind of have those sometimes, and it you just gotta work with your slide. And she cut it back in a little bit. Really smart veteran move by her when she didn't have a good slide, and she set it herself. Bad slide. Oh no.
Artistry.
But she made it.
It's a really important draw here from Strouse. Hope it's tendency to overcompensate after the first one ends up going short. Might be losing a little bit of speed.
Yeah, that happened to us a few times, so it went down just a little bit. It wasn't huge, but
this looks really good. What a draw by Delaney Strouse. Great shot.
Ice in the veins for the youngster.
That double may be there, though, for Peterson.
Ooh, that would be for three if she makes it, huh?
Yeah, I don't think the shooter stays because I think you have to play it over the top. She's looking at just playing it to the narrow side. That rock just went maybe I guess he still would have had the double if it stopped a little higher too, though. So maybe needed to hammer that back to the back of the fours.
Yeah, this is probably it's thinner than it looks to get this over the top. But Tab was looking more on hitting it more closer to the nose to hit it the other way, but I think over the top's the way. You hit about a thin half, third maybe.
So final stone, ninth end. Tab Peterson playing the double for possibly three.
Go back!
What a shot for three.
And there it is. What a shot by Peterson.
You know, she makes those all the time. She's just so good. When it ice in the veins just makes, what a shot. What a shot for three.
Fantastic shot from Tab Peterson for the three in the ninth. Now leads Delaney Strouse 8-5 coming home in this championship game.
The everyday person may not aspire to be a professional athlete or an Olympic athlete. You may just want to be the best person you can be. You just may want to sleep better. You may want to feel better. Thorne has many products that can support all of those things. So it's not just about performing or running faster or jumping higher. It's those little things that go into having a higher quality of life.
So the final end, or possible final end, of this 2023 USA Curling Women's National Championship, Tab Peterson with an incredible double for that three-point end. Champion type of shot, Rich, to go up 8-5.
It might overcurl a little bit.
Strouse will need three to stay in this, and we saw the same situation in the 1-2 game with the roles reversed. Strouse leading by three, and Peterson able to get the four to win the game. So Strouse needs to turn the tables.
What a shot by Tab last end. I mean, that's just, we saw this, you know, in the earlier game too, the, you know, the veterans really, when the pressure's on Tab and John Schuster, I mean, they make them all, you know, and that's why they're winners.
Whoa,
and that's why
really
they're, you know, been to several world championships and won several nationals, you know. So what a great shot though. And I don't think Delaney didn't play anything wrong there. I mean, she played the right strategy. It's just, maybe put that rock in just a little bit better spot, but I mean, man, she hit the lid, and if Tab doesn't make it, she's in total control of the game. But
yeah, it just kind of came down to the Delaney's first coming up short on that come around draw.
Yep.
Tab ended up making the run on the only rock in the fours. If there's two rocks in the 4 foot, then it at least you're making her play the run double instead.
Yep.
And that one in the top eights is still there besides, so. Maybe a little bit of a pocket to use for Team Strouse later on.
Right, same thing.
So what we've been doing in this situation is we would have probably tapped in that corner guard, did the mixed double shot, tapped it in there, and I think, man, if you make that, it's pretty much game over.
Sure.
Two. We need to be even.
I think when you're up three, that's the shot, especially when it's that tight where
even
it is here. Because now Tab, one problem with what she just did there is she's got two rocks side by side in the 4 foot.
Okay. Was like a lot
I'd be tempted to get rid of one of these, Ty, hit one of them, because I don't like where they're sitting right now.
Yeah, I don't disagree, because you're just trying to hold to two even for your opponent. So stones aren't in great place.
And you're just kind of piling in a bunch of stones in the house. I don't think you really want too many in there.
Yeah, like
back eight. Just straight on this nose, I think.
Yeah. You can just call it. We all like
if you
it.
Could play this with like board weight right on the nose and spread both of those to the back, bury, you know, under the corners, that'd be a pretty good shot.
If you could get them behind the corners, that'd be really good. They're just playing, looks like back ring, back, you said back eight. I'm guessing it would probably be more like back 12, back line.
Okay. You aren't moving three rocks very far with back eight.
No.
Go backs. Okay, well, close. Okay, go a little bit. Hard. Good.
Not a bad result.
No, that's fine. Do you like that?
I'd be tempted just to rip the corner right now. Make the double peel on the corners and
there's a chance left. With this shot you could shoot it under a corner. See the clock's only 2:11 left for Peterson.
Hard every bit! Go! One more.
Oh, a good shot.
Yep.
She cleaned it up a little bit. That's a good shot. But now Strouse needs to go under these corners and use the corners she put up.
Yeah, very good shot by Becca Hamilton there. Lose that backing. Yeah. You know, piling those rocks up in the fours, with a possible pocket. Okay. Not going to help Team Peterson. They have everything in they need already right now.
Line's good. Little tight. Straight.
It's going under the corner guard now for Strouse.
Okay. Line's okay.
Just trying to get to top 8 foot.
Okay. I got 14.
They don't have a problem taking this deep as long as it buries.
Real good, Sid. Really
That's
good. Nice
fine.
Pair.
Tab will peel the corner.
If you ever get them both here, it's a big shot. It's pretty much game over.
Tara.
Looks like she might have set this a little. They're sweeping hard to get a piece.
Yep, got it. Good.
Gets enough of it to make the single peel.
You like one more?
I think you got to go under right now.
Yeah.
The other corner instead of throwing another corner because you're just waste. You can get two under. That corner, that's your best chance at three. I don't think you throw up a corner right here.
Yeah, you're going to have a hard time scoring three with your last three if you're just going under a single corner.
Yeah.
Tab will hit this rock immediately right now. That's
right.
In the open.
I'm good.
Yeah, it's this is Anna's first rock, and you're running out of rocks here to get your three. So if you could just get under that other corner, Tab hits the open one, then you work with trying to get another one under the corner, or a freeze of some sort on one of these rocks.
Yeah, if Tab peels this off, then Strouse pretty much has to go under the other corner. Then they hit the open one.
You go under
the math on where it's going to end up. Catches the back of the corner. So Delaney now has to go under that corner guard. They're going to need a miss somewhere.
Can we freeze on the back quad one?
Talking about going on that stone too.
Oh, for sure.
So playing the freeze to the rock in the back of the eights.
What'd you get on mine? 14.
I mean, if you make it good, it's a good, 14-4. Good shot, but you can get under that corner, I think. It's probably the call on this one.
Yeah, it's
here. Intern freeze for Anna O'Hara. It's a little tight to that rock on the top of the button to make it.
Mine's good. 7, 8. Got a curl.
Looks like it has a lot of curling to do.
7, 8. Really got a curl.
Still needs to curl to get off of that rock. It's going to bump the one on the top of the button.
It's a little heavy, yeah.
So I think you're just probably hitting this outside one, right? She's only got two rocks left. She's got a score. Oh, you can play it. No, you can't. That double's probably jamming.
And I kind of think we want to roll out because if I ever leave more.
Timeout called. We'll listen in.
Yeah, I like this. And we won. Yeah. Okay.
I think they decided, Ty, to hit this open one, like what we called here. And I think she said roll out. Don't sit there. So you have room to maybe get other rocks out of there later. But I don't think they want to sit there. They're just going to peel it out. And then this is where we're talking about whether Delaney should have gone in on the one shot earlier. The problem is she might run out of time here. She just, not time, but you know, she's only got two rocks left,
yeah,
right?
Run out of
so
rocks.
If she had the one more under that corner, and then she could maybe do something with those middle reds. So
Peterson just playing the peel on this back stone, kind of hit and roll out.
Whoa!
It's fading a little bit, but just needs contact, and now actually curled up and nosed. So timeout for Team Strouse as well. coach Courtney Benson on the way. There.
Yeah, not very steep, nearly nose.
Yeah. I was looking at that.
My old Super League partner.
Nose tap.
And
yeah.
This could get a little interesting.
No, you're good.
I think if you could nose tap it and just move that just that red one back
a touch
so that it'll go off into the other red one, I think that's what you got to do.
Here, you just hit it nose.
Okay, you're saying freeze to the nose.
Yeah.
Not here.
You could also try, I don't know how you get there, if you could weld on the back one, dead on it.
Yeah.
It's hard to get a yellow out.
Even count if I go here and then hit it, like because of this.
Both teams have plenty of time left to finish this game out, so.
I think she just is double. So we. She'll play something. Like it's not
so
like
you like tap, like just coming frozen
I think
and seeing what she. What
yeah,
happens.
if you tap it I dead nose and move that red stone like 3 inches,
really good, just like
stay a hair high. That
to play
rock
it,
that stayed on that hit from Peterson could be a stopper rock for this double attempt.
Which is why I thought they said they wanted it peeled out of there, but
which
you know
they probably should have in that spot.
There.
So, yeah, just like a 7/8 of the rock tap. Try to move that back stone. I think they might just be playing a freeze from what they pointed to.
But you're right. If you're a little on the left side, high, or now low, I guess is the way they're with that
turn.
Yeah,
then you're just hammering that stone.
Yep.
And it's gone.
All right.
You guys like this broom here, or you like a little less?
No, I like it.
Okay. I think this is a good.
Yep.
Not as curly on this side, but I think this is good.
I think 14-5.
I think so too.
Delaney Strouse is first here in the 10th, trying to find a way to manufacture a three, get this to an extra end.
They said soft right out of her hand, so they're on it.
Sweepers are on this one early. It's been a long week of sweeping a ton of stones, and sweepers are going to need to have one more big one here. Calling four.
I don't know if it's worth doing anything.
Oh.
And that's
really
going
like
to end up short of the paint. And
that's game.
That will be. I don't see a shot for three anywhere in there now.
Yeah, there's no reason to throw this rock right now.
They're actually throwing one in. Trying to find a wheel raise roll in somewhere and not seeing it, Rich.
Yeah, I don't see it either. Not to get four rocks out of there and having to rate, you know, you can run the two guard off the one guard and hopefully it's spilled in, but you can't get rid of all four rocks, so there's nothing.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised Tab's even throwing anything in. Not that it matters. I don't know that she could hurt herself with anything either unless she was playing a hit. Even then, you still got to get two yellows into the house. She picked a good time to throw heat on a draw. The one that doesn't matter.
That's fine. They shook hands.
And they will shake. That is game. Really well played national championship final. Fun one to watch. Team Peterson over Team Strouse, 8-5. Tabitha Peterson, Corey Teese, Becca Hamilton, Tara Peterson, Coach Kathy Overton Clapham will be going on to the world championships in Sandviken, Sweden. A wonderful week from Team Strouse. Took this team to the wire once again. Coming up just a hair short, but such an impressive week. Measuring themselves against the best and made Team Peterson work for every single inch they got in that game.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it was really that one shot, you know, that double that turned the game around, and one miss, and that's the way it goes at this level, you know. But those young ladies will be around again here. They'll be back in this game again and at some point.
And really, the difference in the game, ninth end, Tab Peterson makes a run back and a double on her last two for that three. Half an inch from stuffing it and a steal of one for Team Strouse. But Tab makes no mistake, and good to see it won on made shots, too. So we'll be signing off here, but or for the commentary side of things, but you can still watch the stream and the closing ceremonies for the medal and trophy presentations. USA Curling Interim CEO Dean Gemmel will have the mic. So we will turn it over to him, and thanks to Rich for joining me this afternoon. Thanks to John and Joel in the booth for everything that they've done throughout the week. Thanks to USA Curling for supplying the coverage for this event and Curling Stadium for the technology. Congratulations to our national champions, Team Peterson on the women's side, Team Schuster on the men's side. We wish them the best of luck at the World Championships. Tyler George, Rich Roon, and John Benton, Cam Rittenauer, and Joel Dietz. Thanks for watching.
I want to thank our partners at Curling Stadium who've done the webcast all week. Great job. And our volunteer ice crew, led by Sean Olson, the volunteer ice crew that comes from around the country and here in Denver to make such a surface for our athletes. A couple of weeks ago, this place was good for bull riding, not very good for curling, but we made it that way. I want to thank our officials. You put up with the four draw day and the usual series of challenges. Thank you. I want to thank USA Curling staff, all the group that came out with us have been working hard and much appreciated. And finally, competitors. I want to thank not only our medalists today, our champions, but all the competitors in the field. I love curling and I love to see it played at a high level, and we got that all week, so thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to recognize our winners as well as our silver and bronze medalists. Here to hand out the awards are USA Curling Interim CEO Dean Gimmel and Sporting Director Katie Baker. Starting with the bronze medalists in the men's division, Team Dropkin. Corey Dropkin. Andrew Stolpera. Mark Fenner. Tom Howe. And Coach Mark Lazar. Coming in second place and earning the silver medals, Team Casper. Danny Casper. Luke Violette. Ben Richardson. Chase Sinnott. And Coach Jordan Moulton. And now, the 2023 USA Curling Men's National Champions, Team Schuster. This And now for the women's division, coming in third place and earning the bronze medals, Team Anderson. Sarah Anderson. Taylor Anderson. Lexi Lanigan. And Lita Garborough. And Coach Earl Morris. Now for your silver medalists. Team Strouse. Delaney Strouse. Becca Rogers, Susan Dutt, and Coach Courtney Benson. And now the 2023 USA Curling Women's National Champions, Team Peterson. Tabitha Peterson. Corey TC. Becca Hamilton. Tara Peterson. And Coach Kathy Overton Sherrill. Congratulations to all the teams that participated in the event this